You're watching Unreal Ent Gaming. This is Gohan from Dragon Ball Z. You want to see me turn Super Saiyan, or should I take it to the next level? I'm also the narrator, too. Next time on Dragon Ball Z, make sure and smash subscribe to Unreal Ent Gaming.
As the once angel of the fallen 13th universe looks to have his revenge on the gods who have betrayed him, Merno's story continues following his original introduction and follow-up battle with Broly, Vegeta, and Goku, to which you guys can find those stories and videos located down in the description box below to catch up on, as Merno now has his eyes set in wiping out Universe 7's mightiest warriors. But in the midst of it all, what exactly is Merno's true agenda behind why he is fighting, and what exactly can our heroes do to ever have a chance in stopping him? As once more, before we begin, if you are new to this channel and have a love and passion for all things Dragon Ball and anime related, then be sure to smash that subscribe button on this channel and turn on all notifications to never miss a single upload, along with giving this video a big thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys love Dragon Ball and anime, as well as checking out the official Dragon Ball fan mangas playlist located down in the description box below, to where on that playlist you guys will be able to find all the latest and best Dragon Ball fan mangas created by the community for the community. So be sure to head on down below, check out the official Dragon Ball fan mangas playlist for all the best and latest videos on Dragon Ball fan mangas. As we kick off the Beyond Dragon Ball Super story of Merno vs. Universe 7 manga chapter special, as Merno finally encounters the god of destruction of the 7th universe, Beerus, on his planet, Merno then went along to acknowledge Beerus by telling him, "I was wondering where you were and why you weren't active this entire time, Beerus. But knowing you, I should have figured you'd be sleeping your way through the destruction of your universe, and here I expected more from you. I should have remembered how lazy you gods are. If I had known you'd be sleeping, I would have gotten rid of you in your sleep first before dealing with the rats." As Beerus went along to respond, "I see your mouth is just as big and loud as before you were exiled from your position. But there's something different about you. Where are the others? Where's Whis?" And with Merno pointing up, he then went along to respond, "Up there, along with the rest of those mortal worms. I've had quite the encounter with your Saiyan slaves. Quite interesting creatures indeed. Far different than the ones in the 13th, but they will all be soon dealt with. As you may already suspected, I am a clone of the original, inherited with most of his powers and abilities. The reason why I've come is because it's time to begin eliminating the gods. You 12 will no longer be needed. It's not like you've been doing your job well enough anyway. But before I kill you, I would like to see why you are regarded as the strongest god of destruction among them all. So you have two options, Destroyer. Either fight me using the full extent of your power, or surrender your title and accept your fate in death. I won't ask you twice. Don't forget who you're dealing with here either, Beerus. You gods also played a role in my departure when you chose to remain silent instead of speaking out against an oppressive tyrant that was Zeno. I haven't forgotten. Now what's it going to be?" As Beerus then is shown getting really agitated, he only then responded, "You're more deranged than I thought you'd be, but I see casting you away still did nothing to correct that attitude of yours, Angel. Do not underestimate me, because I am a god and you are an angel. There is a reason why Whis had advised me never to use my full power, but since you're begging for death by knocking on my door, then I'll gladly be the one to answer and accept your death wish. You may be stronger than us gods, but let's not forget that angels like yourself can also die. It's just going to take a bit of effort to do it. I'm annoyed by your tone and lack of respect for the natural order, so consider this challenge accepted. Your final moments will be remembered against me. And with Merno laughing, he only then responds, ha! Final moments with you? Are you still sleeping or what, Beerus? You must be if you believe you have any chance of killing me. I could end your life faster than you can blink, but where would the fun in that be? I'll lower my power to match yours then. I want to have a little fun smacking you around your own planet before I rip you to pieces. So, Merno knows Beerus, and Beerus knows Merno, and because of this, Merno also puts blame on the gods of destruction for remaining silent in his departure, as only then Merno went along to continue by pounding on his chest, I am beyond you in every way possible, Beerus. But if you think differently, then come and show me. And that's exactly what Beerus does, because the second Merno finishes his sentence, Beerus charges right in telling Merno, with pleasure, before right then and there punching Merno directly in the face with such force that it causes Merno to be sent hurtling out into the distance, having to smash through the ground beneath him. And as Beerus stands there, he then went along to comment, "You can stop pretending now. I know that attack didn't actually hurt you, so unless you want to quit while you're ahead, then get up and quit wasting my time, Merno." And with Merno shown dusting himself off and coming back into the fight, he only then replied to Beerus by telling him, "Well, that was a disappointing demonstration from the so-called strongest destroyer among the gods. And here I thought you'd hit harder. Well then, Beerus, if that's the best you can do, then you are as good as dead. You know, I never would have guessed that mortals such as your precious Goku and Vegeta would be able to hit a lot harder than the god of destruction of the 7th universe. Shall I show you how it's done then?" And these comments really irritate Beerus, but Beerus doesn't go without smirking as he replies, "Your mouth is really starting to annoy me. Maybe I'll need to break your jaw so you don't talk anymore." And with Merno charging on in, he only then responded, "Oh, you mean like this?" And the second Merno charges in, Beerus goes into defensive position only to then realize that Merno had completely dematerialized, as Beerus comments, "He can dematerialize?" right before one of Merno's punches actually connects with Beerus. As Beerus is then sent flying back, Merno then teleports through a portal in popping up behind Beerus and telling him, "Indeed, Destroyer, among many other abilities that I am holding off," before kicking Beerus right in the stomach. He then tells him, "Away with you, puny god!" As Beerus is then shown being kicked from the ground into the lake, Merno only then continues to tell him, "You're really not that special, Beerus. I don't see what Whis ever saw within you that there's nothing that I cannot deal with. Isn't it already clear to you that you cannot win alone? I remember Whis training you long ago, and this is the fruits of your training with him? So which one is it, Beerus? Are you as soft as you look, or did you simply waste your time being a god of destruction if mortals have already reached and surpassed your levels of power, such as the Saiyans in this universe? Ha! Pathetic. Or maybe you're hiding your real power from me. Isn't it said that you were the first destroyer to tap into the powers of Ultra Instinct before losing it? Well, where is it?" And with Beerus then slowly emerging from the lake, he then replies, "You're quite the cheeky one. I wasn't expecting for you to possess such interesting abilities, but don't get ahead of yourself here. You've proven to me exactly why you must be destroyed. Am I restricting myself from using my full power? Maybe. Only one way to find that out. But let's make one thing perfectly clear. I won't go down without a fight, and I certainly won't go down to a washed-up, overly delusional disgrace of an angel like yourself. Have I once tapped into Ultra Instinct? Indeed, I did. But make no mistake about it, just because I did so long ago doesn't mean I cannot push myself to achieve it now." And with Merno alluding to the idea that in fact Beerus at one point did achieve Ultra Instinct, and with Beerus implying that indeed if pushed, he could possibly achieve it again, what Merno follows by doing is removing his cape and then telling Beerus, That's the Spirit Destroyer. Well, since I'm finished warming up, why don't you demonstrate to me exactly what my brother had taught you all these years? I'll make this a lot easier for you if you show me. I can sense Whis and that other pest Goku heading here as we speak, so before they arrive, I'd have to enjoy my time with you before they get in our way. And with Beerus grinning, he then responds, "You'll be long dead before they get here." Confident, are we? So you want me to use everything I have on you right now? I hope you're ready for it. And with Merno extending his hands in welcoming this, he only then tells Beerus, "Go ahead, Beerus. I'll give you a freebie and allow you to hit me right here, right now, with as much power as you'd like. And after you do, I am going to then show you and prove to you on why you never stood a chance to begin with. So go on, take your best shot." And with Beerus' aura glowing, he only then smiles in responding, "You're making this too easy for me, Merno. But if this is what you wanted, then far be it for me to keep you waiting then." As Beerus then begins to power up in such a way that one would literally assume that this is the peak of Beerus' power, and with Merno shielding himself, he only then questions this by commenting, "So this is Beerus' true power, huh? Now I see why the other gods were jealous of you and feared your potential. But don't assume that this is going to be nearly as much as it will take to kill me. Especially when you..." And that's when Merno gets cut off, because then Beerus charged right in punching Merno directly in the stomach by asking, "What's wrong? Did you still think I was bluffing?" before uppercutting him right in the jaw and then telling him, "Wasn't expecting this now, were you?" Where did all of that tough talk just go? As he then proceeds to kick Merno in the face, Beerus then winds up grabbing Merno by the throat and telling him, "You dare disrespect my title and my universe? You come onto my home and threaten me with death? Such an act is unforgivable and is only met with death." And with Merno shown being choked by Beerus, he only then went along to respond, "So you weren't bluffing when you said you were hiding your power. You think you can kill me?" As Beerus responds, "Think? At this point, I know I can, angel or not. You will know your place among the gods." But then right there, Merno quickly breaks free as he went along to then tell Beerus after spinning him, "How dare you defile me with your filth? This will not end on your terms, but rather yours." As he then grabs onto Beerus' throat, he then tells him, "They will end on mine." So not only did Merno counter by breaking free and thus spinning Beerus around, but the second Beerus actually made his 360 transition, Merno then followed by grabbing Beerus by the throat and then having to do the exact same thing by choking Beerus and then having to follow by squeezing him just as Beerus did, as Beerus went along to respond, "I'll die before I let you destroy the seventh." As Beerus's tail then comes in handy by wrapping itself around Merno's throat, what Beerus followed up by doing was then punching Merno away, and with Merno breaking the ground beneath him, he then went along to tell Beerus, "That was a dirty move, Beerus. All bets are off," as Beerus responds, "There are no rules in this fight." And with Merno overhearing this, he then went along to respond, "Really now? Well then, you just made my game that much more interesting now, Beerus." Because now it seems as if Merno had now picked up on something that Beerus is completely unaware of. With Merno continuously taunting the God of Destruction, he only then went along to tell Beerus, "So since we aren't playing by the rules anymore, then how about you show me what you can truly do? If you can handle what's coming." And Beerus wastes little time in then having to charge directly at Merno by telling him, "Just you wait until I get a hold of you then." And as soon as Beerus throws the first shot, Merno quickly gets out of the way and then telling Beerus, "Get a hold of me, you say? And how exactly do you plan on doing that if you're having trouble catching me?" As Merno then latches onto Beerus' tail, he then proceeds to swing Beerus around and throwing him out into the distance by telling him, You'll have to try again, Destroyer. So, Merno is now beginning to take this a lot more lightly than how he was during the beginning of this battle, and as Merno stands there, he only then goes on to tell Beerus, "I'm starting to feel pity for you, Beerus. And here I was expecting so much more from you. There are still a great many things that I still haven't revealed to you, but in time, I will. Until then, I'm just going to continue to smack you around this rock, and there's nothing you're going to do to stop me. You simply aren't strong enough," and as soon as Beerus teleports behind Merno, Merno doesn't even bat an eye, as of course he continues to look on and commenting, "Still don't believe me?" And the second Beerus attacks Merno from behind, what Merno does is counter Beerus by grabbing onto his punch without even looking at him, and the second Merno looks back at Beerus, he only then asks him, "Well, are you a believer now? This is fun! I love seeing that desperate look on your face. The feeling of hopelessness, the feeling of defeat. Now you know what I felt like when you all turned your backs to me." And Beerus isn't having it, because then, as soon as he backs his hand away, he then proceeds to grab Merno with his left hand by the hair, and then pulling him back by telling him, "If you think I'm finished with you, then I must have hit you harder than I thought I did. This battle of ours isn't over until you are turned into dust." And as soon as Beerus pulls Merno back more, he winds his fist back as he's just about to hit him and telling him, "You won't be talking so much after I punch a hole through your head, angel." And even though Beerus is not letting up and giving up in this battle, the second Beerus attempts to hit Merno, Merno quickly then disappears by using his portal, as he only told Beerus, "Like I said, Beerus, you'll have to catch me first." As he then opens another portal by Beerus' side, he only then emerges by punching Beerus in the face by telling him, "And the higher you take your power, the more I will match it as you get stronger. An embarrassment of a god you are." And with Beerus stumbling back, Merno then continues, "But I will give you some credit for your efforts. You sure know how to take a hit. Must have picked that up from Whis. Typical. But that won't save you. You can only take so much before your body begins to break, and when that moment happens, you will be finished, Beerus. So what's it going to be? Are you going to give up and let me kill you, or will you continue to fight a losing battle?" And with Beerus having to wipe away the mark on his face, he only then responds, "As I said, I'm not done with you just yet. I'd perish before giving myself to another in battle. Don't you worry, when the opportunity presents itself, I won't hesitate. And when it does, I will erase you from history as if you never existed. On my honor as a destroyer, I will find a way to destroy you." So, Merno seems to be toying around with Beerus in this idea that no matter how strong Beerus gets, Merno is going to somehow match him in power, because keep in mind, during the beginning of this encounter, Merno went along to tell Beerus that he will suppress himself and lower his power to match Beerus for the sole reason of wanting to have some fun with him before having to kill him off, as Merno then went along to tell Beerus, "You are all the same in my eyes. That pathetic Omni King should have done us all the favor by destroying this universe when he had the chance. Guess I'll have to finish what that brat should have started when he had the chance." As Beerus went along to respond, "It's ironic how you say such things about Grand Zeno when you're alone, but wouldn't dare think about saying that to his face when he's around. Quite the coward, Merno. If you think I'll allow you to kill me without putting up a fight, then your brain must have been erased along with your universe when the Omni King exiled you when he did." And that really annoyed Merno, as he went along to then ask him, "What did you say to me?" With Beerus responding, "What's wrong? Did I strike a nerve there, mighty angel?" As Merno replies, "You wish. Now stop wasting my time and show me what you got." And Beerus does exactly that, because then Beerus quickly fires a barrage of energy blasts directly at Merno's direction, and even though Merno is now beginning to see that Beerus is not going to go down without a fight, as soon as Beerus begins to fire off these energy attacks, Merno then so casually begins to deflect each and every single attack behind him in a very casual way, in a sense to where these blasts have literally no effect on Merno. He only then went along to tell Beerus, "You're making this too too easy for me. These attacks will do nothing to aid you from your own destruction. Allow me to demonstrate this to you. And the second Merno charges on in, he then goes on ahead to tackle Beerus onto the ground and telling him, "Foolish god, you left yourself wide open." And as they begin to roll on the ground, Merno gets the better of Beerus by then slamming him onto the floor. And as Merno gets on top of Beerus, he only then puts his forearm against his throat and telling him, "Since you love running your mouth, I figured I'd do something to shut it since you're beginning to speak about things that you know absolutely nothing about." And with Merno then beginning to punch Beerus while on the floor, he only then tells him, "Get up, Destroyer! Show me your power! Show me why you were selected to rule this universe!" So, Merno is now beginning to become the aggressor in this battle, in not only by further enticing Beerus to show him more of his true power, but also now, he has the upper hand by not only gaining leverage on Beerus, but now punching him while he's on the ground. And as Merno continuously throws shot after shot, punch after punch, in literally caving Beerus' face in while on the ground, he only then continued to tell him, "Was this honestly supposed to be your full power? What a joke. No ultra instinct, no real challenge. You're worse than I thought you'd be. You've grown soft over the years. You wasted your potential." And as Merno continues to pound away at Beerus' face, he only then tells him, "I am going to grind you into pieces so my brother can come back and find what's left of you on the floor. You gods never deserved such titles. You're all a waste." And with Beerus having to be shown in tremendous amounts of pain, over out somewhere in deep outer space, Whis and Goku are traveling back onto the planet as Goku went along to ask, "Hey Whis, do you sense that? Is it me, or does it feel like Beerus's energy is slowly starting to fade? Is there anything we can do? What happens if we don't make it in time? Can Merno really kill him? What happens if Beerus dies?" As Whis went along to respond, "I feel it too, but Lord Beerus is not one to go down without putting up a fight. Merno can indeed kill him, but why he hasn't yet is beyond me to answer. If he dies, then I will cease to operate and will be sent back to the Angel Realm." We're almost there. So Goku and Whis are at a hurry to get back to Beerus' planet because they know that Beerus is in trouble, and Merno does in fact possess the power to kill Beerus, but why he hasn't is still yet to be answered. And as we make our way back to Beerus' planet, we are then shown how Merno is continuously pounding on Beerus' face as he then went along to tell him, "Fight back, weakling! Fight back! Fight for your honor! Fight for your universe, Destroyer! Show me what you can do! Show me!" And the second Merno stops and gets off of Beerus, he only then looks down and telling him, "Just as I thought. Unless you're hiding something from me, this battle is over. If I could beat you down this badly, then just imagine what the original can do. Your time as God of Destruction of this universe is over, Beerus. You should have trained for moments like this instead of spending your days being lazy and sleeping. Now look at you. My universe was once the strongest in all the realms. We had no weak destroyers like you in my world. A shame that we settled for something like this. You should have accepted your fate like a true warrior instead of embarrassing yourself like this. You're not the god of destruction. You're the god of wasted potential. Your heart and determination won't save you from what's coming. You should have been erased instead of my universe, but it doesn't matter. You're finished." And as Merno sticks his hand out, he only then tells Beerus, "I hope they remember you. To the afterlife with you." As all of a sudden, Beerus then begins to power up in a rage-like state, to where the sheer force of Beerus's power is now beginning to push Merno back, as Merno went along to comment, "So, you were hiding your power from me this entire time after all. What force? So, you finally decided to show me your true self, I see. It's about time you did. And here I was beginning to doubt you, Beerus." And with Beerus shown standing there with this incredible aura surrounding him, Beerus then went along to tell Merno, I haven't used my full power in millions of years, so consider yourself honored to face me at my highest. This is where you die, as Merno then replies, what a fine display of power, but it still won't be enough to destroy me. With Beerus then responding, really? Let's find out then, shall we? As Merno responds, by all means try. So Merno's really not concerned even with Beerus having to max out his power and going all out. Merno instead is actually welcoming this, as we only then go back into outer space with Whis and Goku shown trying to do their very best to get to Beerus as quickly as they can. Goku then went along to ask Whis, do you think Beerus could somehow defeat Merno without our help? I can sense a huge spike in Beerus' power just now. Is he using his full power? As Whis went along to reply, Lord Beerus had not used his full power in millions of years, since the days of our training, as a matter of fact. So for him to use it now could only mean that Merno is getting the better of him and is now forced to use this power for the first time since. Now Whis confirms to Goku that Beerus really hasn't used his full power since the days of his original training with Whis. As we then go back to Merno and Beerus, they are both shown struggling in a test of might, as Merno went along to tell Beerus, impressive destroyer, but you can't keep this up for long and you know it, with Beerus then having to respond, I'll destroy you before anything happens to me that would prevent my victory. And with Beerus shown slightly pushing back, he then continues, you will regret at the day where you crossed me, Merno. I swear you will. With Merno then responding, as if you ever had a chance, Beerus. As he then quickly flees the scene and having to move behind through a portal, he only then goes on to tell Beerus, you'll have to be a lot quicker than that to do it. As of course Beerus then stumbles forward, Merno then opens up a portal above Beerus and double axe handling him across the head and telling him, and you simply don't have what it takes to win. So Merno now is clearly taunting Beerus, he's antagonizing him further in, basically telling him that no matter how strong he actually gets, he cannot possibly beat him, but Beerus quickly counters this by having to then turn the tides and then kicking Merno in the face by telling him, I'll be the judge of whether or not I have what it takes to break you. As impressive as you are, I still have more left within me than you assume I do. As Beerus then grabs onto Merno's face, he then proceeds to slam him down on the ground and then telling him, you are incredibly formidable, but it's time we end this. I've had enough of your games. As Beerus then kicks Merno out into the distance, he then follows by telling him, allow me to finish what should have happened millions of years ago. As the most powerful destroyer, you will feel every bit of my power. With Beerus then having to put his hands together in creating a massive sphere of energy that seemingly resembles that of the sphere of destruction, Merno then looks up and having to question this by stating, what's this? He's going for broke. He'll destroy this entire planet if that attack bypasses me. As Beerus then goes on to comment, you've disrespected me long enough. It's time you get what's coming since the beginning. Now don't dream of coming back to my universe again. And Beerus means business, because then he goes on ahead to launch this attack directly down at Merno by telling him, I'll blow you to bits. Feel the power of the mightiest god of destruction. And with this blast having to come down, Merno braces himself as he went along to comment, arrogant fool. This will not be the end of me. As Merno then goes on to clutch onto the attack, there is a momentary struggle with, of course, both Merno and Beerus pushing. Beerus then, in absolute anger, went along to comment, accept your death and never return here again. And with Merno slowly shown being pushed back, he only then comments, curse you, your arrogance and the mindful heart for the life within this universe disgusts me. You won't get rid of me that easy. And as Beerus begins to then shout back, he only then told Merno, you will not be allowed to destroy my universe. And as the blast begins to overtake Merno, he then went along to eerily grin in responding, foolish god. We shall see. As the blast then completely overtakes Merno, there is a massive explosion on Beerus' planet, with of course Beerus having to be shown huffing and puffing afterwards. He only then went along to comment, there's no way he could have been able to survive that. but I still sense something below, as down within the crater we get to see how Merno is shown in a defensive-like position, with Beerus then responding, unbelievable. He's still alive, but he's weakened. Yes, because this was the opportunity that Beerus was seeking ever since the beginning, and as Beerus blitzes in front of Merno, he then sticks his hand out in telling Merno, you're lucky to even be standing right now, but that's all about to change. You are the only other person to ever push me this far in battle before outside of Whis. If your soul wasn't as dirty, you would have made for a great angel to a god. I am going to erase you from existence forever. Hakai, but right before Beerus can actually Hakai Merno, Merno delivers a gut-wrenching shot to Beerus' stomach, which causes Beerus to not only lose focus, but he's coughing up blood, his body seems to tremble as Merno went along to respond, I will never allow for you to do that, Beerus. It's not that simple, and with Beerus staggering back and holding onto his stomach, he went along to then comment, what tremendous force! Where did that come from? Curse you! And as soon as Beerus rushes back in, he only then attempted to attack Merno, with Merno having to tell him, it was as I kept telling you, Beerus, I am beyond you, and your power, although great, will not be enough to destroy me. So Beerus was just about to Hakai Merno. He was just about to erase Merno from existence until Merno had somehow blitzed Beerus to the point where Beerus is now beginning to question as to where this power had come from, and with Merno clutching onto Beerus' fist, he only then went along to tell him, I had lowered my power to match yours, remember? Don't think otherwise here, vermin. I used you to see where you stood within this universe as a god of destruction. And you've given me all the answers I needed and was searching for. But since the beginning, you were fighting a losing battle. And this really catches Beerus by surprise, because Beerus went along to reply, how dare you make a mockery of me and my title, you disgusting embarrassment of an angel. And the second Beerus tries to attack again, he then utters, how dare you? But Merno is easily ducking and dodging and avoiding all of Beerus' attacks and telling him, fighting out of rage now, are you, Beerus? It seems your anger towards me is making you fight sloppy. You can attack me as much as you want to now. You've defeated yourself a long time ago. This anger you have will only take you so far until you start making mistakes and slipping up. So Merno is not only taunting Beerus and telling him, despite you having to fight in the name of rage, really isn't going to do anything to alleviate the situation. He then quickly followed by once again striking Beerus in the stomach by telling him, here's an example of my full power, Destroyer. Can you feel it? And Beerus' body is rattled as he then drops to his knees. Merno only then tells him, and here I expected more from you. I even thought you were going to show me your ultra instinct. Shame. And with Beerus looking up, he then told Merno, I will fight you until death, with Merno responding, good! That's the spirit. Oh, since you can't seem to accept it yet, allow me to show you a little trick. I've been keeping this up my sleeve this entire time. As Merno then transforms into a very familiar-like power with a familiar aura, a familiar outlook, he only then asks Beerus, does this look a little familiar to you, Beerus? With Beerus uttering, he has Ultra Instinct? So Merno, in fact, does indeed have Ultra Instinct, with, of course, Merno then powering back down, he then responded, indeed. I also can tap into the powers of Ultra Instinct, but given my status, I have no need to use it. Not yet, of course, as he then sinisterly grins down at Beerus, he then continues, this is only but a small portion of my power. Do you now see why you never stood a chance from the beginning? That look in your eyes says it all, as he then sticks his hand out and telling him, now to end this little game of ours for good. What was that little move you called again? Oh yes, that's right. Hakai. But right before Merno actually went along to Hakai Beerus, out of nowhere, Merno is then struck in the face and having to be sent flying back. And because of this, Whis and Goku had finally made it back in time, with Super Saiyan Blue Goku defending Beerus and responding, "No matter how many times you decide to show your ugly face, we will always be right here to stop you in your tracks. We've got some unfinished business, Merno. Let's do this." With Merno feeling the effects after being attacked by Goku out of nowhere, Merno further proceeded to wipe away the blood from his mouth as he only then went along to comment, "Well, this was an unexpected surprise, and here I thought you'd arrive a little later, but I guess you must have felt Beerus' power fading, so you came in for the rescue. How cute. If I could physically throw up in my mouth right now, I would. A destroyer saved by a mortal in battle? Is this what we've come to? Another reason for me to erase the multiverse and start from scratch. But since you're here now, I might as well destroy you both at once." And with Goku shown stepping in front of Beerus, Beerus went along to stand back up and then telling Goku, "Where did you come from, Goku? I don't need you to fight for me. This is my battle. I am owed this as the destroyer of the seventh." With Goku responding, "Yeah, well, now's not the time to argue about who's going to fight first. If we don't kill him right now, then he's going to destroy everything, including us. We have some unfinished business, and I'm tired of fighting these clones. So I'm going in to stop him before getting to the original." As Beerus is shown getting angry, he then went along to respond, "You cannot face him by yourself, mortal. Don't you dare defy my judgment now. This is my fight to finish, and I'm going to finish it alone." And Goku really doesn't want to hear it because he ends up charging on in and then having to tell Beerus, "Yeah, well, I'm not waiting around anymore. If you want to jump in, you're more than welcome to, but now it's my turn to step up." And with Goku attempting to strike Merno, with Merno having to move out of the way, he only then went along to tell Goku, "You stupid Saiyan, did you forget that you cannot possibly rival me using this form?" And with Beerus shown standing back up, Whis went along to then tell him, "If Goku continues to fight him like this, he will certainly be killed. Goku has engaged Merno several times since you've been sleeping, my lord," with Beerus having to respond, "How did this runt even survive the Omni King's erasure? This idiot Goku is going to get himself killed. Do not intervene unless I give you the order, Whis. I can sense that you desperately want to." So Beerus can now sense that Whis desperately wants to intervene in facing off against Merno. However, unless Beerus or the Grand Priest gives that order, Whis cannot possibly intervene, with Whis then having to respond, "I know we have our rules to uphold, but please allow for my assistance, Lord Beerus. Both you and Goku are at a vast disadvantage if this continues." With Beerus then turning his head in anger, he then went along to shout, "You will stay put until I give you the order, Whis. This is my fight. I will call for you if I am in need, but this is between me and him, not Goku." As over back with Goku, Merno is shown punching Goku directly in the face by telling him, "You have some nerve coming back to fight me after what you and those other Saiyans did to me." And with Goku shown being punched into the distance, Merno then went along to tell him, "I'm going to take my time breaking you down before I end your life, Saiyan." As only then, Beerus then quickly intervenes by punching Merno in the face by telling him, "Don't forget who you're fighting here, Angel. I am not finished with you just yet. This is between me and you." And Merno is shown very annoyed as he went along to cry out, "You dirty destroyer." As of course Merno's body is also shown flying through the landscape, he then quickly breaks his momentum and then using his hand to swipe on down as he went along to tell Beerus, "Down with you, Beerus. Did you forget what I had told you? Well, here's another little trick I've yet to show you all. This is my gravity binding technique, a force so powerful that not even a god could escape. So since you want to be the first to die, then far be it from me to keep you waiting." And with Beerus bound on the ground in his attempts of standing back up, he then went along to tell Merno, "You won't keep me down forever, you cheating waste of an angel." And Merno is smiling on down as he went along to respond, "Then why are you having such a tough time standing back up if you plan on not staying down forever then? weak. Just like I thought, and with Beerus shown desperately trying to stand back up, with the force of the gravity weighing him down, Beerus then responded, "You won't keep me down forever. I will get back up, and when I do, I'm going to grind your bones to pieces. Release me from this bind!" And with Whis looking on absolutely nervous, he then went along to comment, "I can't watch this. They can't do this alone. Merno's baiting them. How does he keep coming back? There must be something I can do to aid them," as only then Merno turns his head as he begins to notice and feel something coming from Whis, as Merno went along to tell him, "Your energy's beginning to flare, Whis. Are you planning on breaking our law to save these creatures?" "Don't worry, Whis. I still haven't forgotten what you and the Grand Priest had done to me on that garbage planet Vampa. Unless you want to be the first to die, then don't you dare even think about getting in our way." So, it appears that Whis does in fact want to intervene in this battle against Merno, especially with Merno having to then sense this for himself. He then went along to tell Whis, "Once I'm done with these two, I will personally enjoy kicking you around this rock before I pay you back for your betrayal." As out of nowhere, Goku comes swooping on in and kicking Merno in the neck by then telling him, "And here's my payback for kicking me earlier. You shouldn't have taken your eyes off me." And with Merno having to once again break his momentum in latching down onto the ground, he then went along to shout, "You cursed Saiyan! How dare you intervene! You won't survive! Between you and the god, I will rid you both from this world." With Beerus now being able to stand back up, Beerus went along to then shout at Goku by telling him, "I told you, Goku, I don't need your help in this battle against him. I will not tell you to stay out of my way again." With Goku then angrily replying to Beerus and telling him, "With all due respect, Lord Beerus, this isn't the time to argue about whose turn it's going to be to fight him. He's coming. Lord Beerus, we have to fight him together. He's a lot stronger than he's letting off." And with Merno charging on in, Beerus went along to respond to Goku by telling him, "Just don't get in my way," as Merno comments, "Since you want to stand together, then you will both die together." Now bear in mind, Beerus doesn't really want or need Goku's help in this battle because he would rather instead go down fighting Merno by himself versus having to have Goku's assistance, but being the fact that Goku is now pleading with him and working together for the sake of having to take him down, we now make our way to an unknown planet, as of course it goes on to read, "Meanwhile, on a distant planet in Universe 7, the Grand Priest is now shown training Vegeta, as the Grand Priest went along to tell Vegeta, 'Get up, Vegeta, and try again. You'll need to match your power along with your speed in order to have a greater impact with your attack.'" Which, if you take a look at the landscape surrounding the area, there are craters all around the area. It looks like an absolute war zone, as of course we then go towards taking a look at Vegeta, who looks incredibly battle damaged, bloody, and tired. He only then went along to comment, "I don't understand. How come I can't land a single hit on you? How are you this powerful? Tell me how! Every single time I come at you with my best, you effortlessly put me down." With the Grand Priest responding, "Because you are yet to evolve beyond this current level of power. If you were to battle Merno alone, then you would certainly die. Get up and come at me with your full power again. No matter what happens, I need you to continue to break your limits." And with Vegeta standing up, he then responded, "I don't know how I'm standing back up, but I refuse to let my limits be my weakness. I don't care how many times I have to try. I will defeat you, and I will push myself beyond my current limits to become the strongest warrior throughout the entire multiverse." With Vegeta then ascending into Super Saiyan Blue Evolution and crying out, "I refuse to let this be my limit!" With a spectacular aura having to engulf him, the Grand Priest then went along to respond, "You possessed vast amounts of potential for someone who isn't a god or angel, so I expect nothing less of your full power each and every single time we engage in battle, Vegeta. To defeat Merno, you will have to obtain a power far beyond your evolution form if you plan on standing up to him alone. He's adapted, and so should you. Now come at me with all you have. So despite Vegeta having to take such a beating, the Grand Priest continues to order Vegeta and not stopping throughout the course of this battle, as of course the Grand Priest then turns his back towards him. He then went along to tell him, "However, I will not hold back against you. Even if it kills you, you will fight me as if your life depended on it," which it does. Now once again, come at me with everything you have. And Vegeta does just that, because as soon as he charges on in, he attempted to strike the Grand Priest, with the Grand Priest having to so casually move out of the way. Vegeta then went along to utter out, "I don't care if you're the strongest in the multiverse or not. One day I will surpass you by any means. I hail from the mightiest warrior race in all of creation, and I as its prince. Quit making me out into a joke. Fight me," with the Grand Priest responding, "You'll need to be much faster than that, Vegeta. You're fighting out of anger, Vegeta. Your rage blinds you from using your full potential. As powerful as you are, this concept will only get you so far," with of course Vegeta shown attempting to punch the priest as many times as he physically could, with none of his punches having to connect. Out of nowhere, the Grand Priest then throws one casual elbow shot to Vegeta's gut, as he then tells him, "It's one of many flaws that needs to be corrected." And mind you, this one single shot to Vegeta's gut actually caused him to power back down into his base form. With Vegeta clutching onto his stomach, he then uttered, "How is this possible? You weren't even looking at me. Why does it feel so heavy?" With the Grand Priest then telling him, "Although I may be stronger than Merno, he is not that far behind. The original, that is, not his clones. If you hope to win, you must overcome your limits." With the Grand Priest then turning his head, he then uttered out, "We will not stop. You will engage with me again. Right now. We will take a break when I say it's time. Now from the top." So this training session seems to be so grueling that despite the punishment that Vegeta is receiving, it's still used as a stepping stone to get him where he needs to be. As we then go back to Goku and Beerus, Goku is shown lying on the ground back down in his base form, as he then went along to comment, "What's with this guy? I'm no match for him like this. I feel like I'm fighting a brick wall. He just keeps coming." With Beerus shown engaging against Merno, Merno only went along to tell Beerus, "You're quite the stubborn one, aren't you, Beerus? Your mortal pet can hardly stand on his feet, which means you'll be the next one to fall." And with Goku shown struggling to stand back up, he then went along to say to himself, "Damn this guy, I have no other choice but to use everything I have. Be with me, I need this power. It's the only way for us to win. I need to focus. My body is shaking. Stay calm. Focus. Focus. It's the only way." With of course Beerus shown further engaging against Merno as Goku is preparing to tap into a greater power, with Beerus then having to tell Merno, "I will not lose to you. I am a god." But Merno is not affected, because he slowly then raises his head up and telling Beerus, "You are nothing." As he then proceeds to then uppercut Beerus in the face by telling him, "Your power is gone. You have nothing left to offer, Beerus." With Beerus shown hitting the ground beneath him, Merno then continues, "Before you can pull any tricks out of your hat, I am going to finish this battle like I should have when I came here." As Merno then sticks his hand out, he then tells Beerus, "This ends here. You had this coming. Goodbye, Destroyer." As Merno fires down a massive energy blast, which seemingly enough should have gotten the job done, out of nowhere, Merno notices that Beerus is now gone. As Merno then questions this by commenting, "What? He's gone? But how? That blast was far too close and quick for him to have moved out of the way." As only then it is shown that Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku had in fact saved the day by rescuing Beerus, he only then went along to tell Merno, "We aren't going to go down that easily, Merno. You pushed me into a corner and now I'm coming back at you with everything I've got. This will be the last thing you witness before you die. Beerus doesn't seem too pleased with Goku having to assist him, as Beerus went along to then tell Goku, "Let's get one thing straight, Saiyan. I don't and never asked for your help against him. He came here, so this is my fight to finish, you got that?" And with Beerus separating himself from Goku and getting into fighting position, Beerus then continues, "This will never happen again, I can promise you that, so stay out of my way as I fight him. Ultra Instinct or not, you will not take this away from me, Saiyan. Am I understood?" With Goku responding, "As long as he's dead, I don't care if you finish him. I'm not going to chance him making it out of this with our heads under his belt and the universe in danger." And with Merno overhearing this and grinning, he then went along to respond, "How cute. A mortal saving and protecting a destroyer. Is this what you've been reduced to, Beerus? You still don't get it, do you, Goku? As long as the original lives, you cannot kill what I am. What I am? The original dwarves, but you'll soon find that out after I beat you both into the ground and I rid you from this world. This is where the game begins to get very interesting, so I advise you both to show me what you can do. No restrictions, no distractions. Killing you both would be the most satisfying accomplishment. Now, let's begin. Show me what you can do." And mastered Ultra Instinct Goku wastes little time, as he is the first person to charge on in and commenting, "With pleasure." And Beerus once again is annoyed, because he went along to then shout, "Damn you, Goku! I said he was mine!" And as soon as Goku speed blitz right towards Merno, he then quickly gets behind him, as Merno went along to respond, "A brilliant display of speed, but attacking me from behind isn't going to work, mortal." With Goku responding, "Who said I was the one who was going to attack you? Because this was the plan. The plan was for Goku to speed blitz his way behind Merno and creating a distraction, and because of this, Beerus found his opening in striking Merno directly in the stomach by then telling him, "You shouldn't have taken your eyes off me, Merno," with Merno commenting, "You disrespectful destroyer," as he latches onto Beerus' arm and then continuing, "I will mount your head as a trophy to remember your fall throughout all of time." But then, Goku quickly inserts himself by backhanding Merno and then directly telling him, "Not if we blow yours clean off your body like we did on Vampa first." And with Merno's body sent flying, Beerus quickly capitalizes in teleporting right in front of Merno and then telling him, "As long as I'm breathing, you will never take my title away." And the second Beerus kicks Merno away, the symmetry between Goku and Beerus is very powerful, because the second Beerus kicks Merno away, Goku capitalizes by then teleporting in front of Merno and double axe handling Merno straight down onto the ground, and with Merno hitting the ground, he only then notices how Goku is charging right back down at him, as Merno then went along to tell Goku, "The more I continue to see your face, the more annoyed I am with why you're still breathing." And right before Goku can make initial contact in stomping down on Merno's stomach, what Merno ends up doing is creating a portal right in between Goku and Merno that causes Goku to go hurtling right through the portal, as Merno tells him, "I haven't forgotten about you or what you've done, Saiyan. Don't assume victory. Off you go to the next dimension." And with Goku shown hurtling right through, he then cried out, "What the no?" before vanishing completely. But Beerus has not forgotten about Merno, because the minute Merno looks up, Beerus winds up firing multiple ki blasts down on the ground and then telling him, "I said never to take your eyes off me, angel." And Merno quickly, as a response, dematerializes and commenting, "Annoying pile of trash. Now I'm beginning to see why your death is needed." And due to this dematerialization, he winds up then stepping through another portal right next to Beerus and punching him in the face and commenting, "Who said I forgot about you, destroyer? Your pet won't be getting in our way for a while, just in time for me to rip you to pieces. Don't forget that this is my game, and I make the rules. Not you, and certainly not the mortal." So, Merno assumes now that he had not only outsmarted Goku by sending him to a different dimension, but being the fact that Merno has Beerus now right where he wants him, unbeknownst to Merno, the same portal that he had just used to punch Beerus through, Goku winds up emerging out of, as he went along to then tell him, Your portals aren't going to save you this time. As Goku winds up kicking Merno on the side, Goku then continues, "I am far from finished with you. You're the one who should be afraid." And as Merno hits the ground, Beerus once again stands back up annoyed as he went along to tell Goku, "How many times do I have to tell you to stay out of my way, Goku? What is with this guy? His power feels bottomless." He doesn't seem phased. As Goku touches back down, he then went along to respond, "It feels like we're running in circles with him, Lord Beerus. Unless we reach and destroy the original, then we're going to be at a constant war against him and his clones unless we find the source." And with Merno overhearing this and swiping the dust away, he then went along to acknowledge this by responding, "You will never find the original, mortal. When I'm ready to end it, then you will personally see and experience this for yourself. Only then will you begin to understand. You two are quite troublesome. Such an unusual partnership between a god and a mortal. What an abomination. What happened to you, Beerus? You were once a mighty destroyer, and now look at you. This universe is quite annoying, as I've come to find out that universes 5, 6, 11, and 12 are as well. But they will all be dealt with. I wonder which one of you I will kill first." So, with Goku acknowledging the fact that they must find and get to the original if they plan on stopping this, because if they don't, then they're going to continuously battle an endless amount of Mernos, because with Merno endlessly being able to clone himself, there seems to be a huge disadvantage for our heroes, whereas Merno seems to hold the upper hand in having the numbers game. As of course Merno now begins to get even more angry, he then went along to comment, "Maybe I'll start by killing you, Saiyan. You've been a constant thorn on my side since I met you, and yet you refuse to accept that you cannot possibly destroy me. You're the most annoying of them all. It was as I had told you since the day I met you. You will never rival my power. You will never destroy who or what I've become. You will never deny me of my revenge, and you will never surpass my power. A mortal such as yourself needs to be put in his place for his defiance." With Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku responding, "Then why don't you put your money where your mouth is and do something about that then, if I'm so problematic for you and your plans? That's if you can." And with Merno grinning, he then responded, "Oh, don't you worry, Saiyan. Your time will come. Very soon, in fact. It might be sooner than you think. You've signed your death wish against me a long time ago. Don't think you're safe." And with Goku and Beerus completely unaware that there's a small portal opening up behind them, Merno then continues, "And if you think I haven't prepared for you and your annoying friends, well then, you might want to think again." As out of nowhere, yet another Merno comes swooping out of the portal and punching Goku in the face by then telling him, "Surprise, mortal! Happy to see me again? I could do this all day. Can you?" And with Beerus flabbergasted, he then uttered, "What the hell?" Because Beerus is completely unaware that Merno is in fact able to do this, as he went along to then ask, "Since when was an angel able to clone himself like this before?" And that's when Merno finds his opening in punching Beerus directly in the stomach by then telling him, "Shut your mouth, you disgrace! What was it you were just saying? Ah, yes, that's right. You shouldn't have taken your eyes off me." So, Merno kind of uses Beerus' exact quotes as a means of reverse psychology, with of course the secondary Merno having to be shown battling Goku. He then went along to tell Goku, "I'm still so surprised that a mortal such as yourself could achieve and use Ultra Instinct like this. But your skills are unbalanced. I could see the cracks forming." And with Goku attempting to strike Merno, Merno grabs onto Goku and telling him, "A rookie's greatest mistake," before flinging him out into the distance, he went along to then utter, "Getting too comfortable in battle." So this clone version of Merno thinks that Goku is getting a tad bit comfortable in battle, all the while on the other side, the first Merno continues his battle against Beerus as he went along to then tell him, "Now where were we? Ah yes, beating you into mush and ending your life, that's right. What's wrong? Fight back. You're beginning to lose focus of this battle. Your guard is breaking and your power is slowly slipping away, Beerus. And this is bad, so much so that as Whis is observing the fight himself, he then went along to comment, They cannot possibly keep this up for long, unless they find a way to destroy the clones before their powers are completely exhausted. Goku may hold off longer than Beerus, but even his power isn't promised to hold off long enough to win. I also sense a great disturbance. Energy leaving this world, but why? Could it be? Something's not right. He's up to something. I can feel it. What are you hiding from us, Merno? And with Merno also having to be shown fighting Beerus, he then senses how Whis seems to be noticing something, with Merno then having to smirk and acknowledging his brother by telling him, "Don't even think about it, Whis. Our time will come very soon, you traitor. I have special plans for you, don't you worry. We haven't engaged against one another since the time when we were only children. I still owe you for helping these mortals reverse time to destroy me." As we then go back to Ultra Instinct Goku's battle with the clone Merno winds up punching Goku in the throat by then asking, "Where did all that bravado go, Saiyan? Did you honestly believe you were going to win this battle?" As Beerus winds up grabbing his Merno by the face, he then went along to utter, "Whis isn't your concern here. Don't forget who you're fighting here, Angel." To where Beerus proceeds to toss the first Merno directly into the second one's direction and commenting, "Away with you," as of course the two Mernos wind up smacking up against each other. Beerus only then winds up joining Goku next to him, as Beerus went along to acknowledge Goku by telling him, "Your favor is returned, Saiyan. Handle what's yours and stay out of my way. The faster we destroy him, the better." As Goku went along to respond, "He's toying with us. It's now or never, Lord Beerus. He's too dangerous to keep around, and if this continues, then we're finished. We have to take them out now." As of course the two Mernos wind up standing back up, they then went along to respond, "No matter what it is that the two of you do, you will never be able to overtake us. Not with the plans we have for you." As Beerus went along to then acknowledge Goku by telling him, "Don't hold anything back, Saiyan. Now's not the time to think with your feelings. Use the power of the gods as best as you can." And with everyone then getting ready, Merno went along to respond, "It appears as if you both seem tired. Giving up? You won't survive what's about to come. Prepare yourselves, because this is where the game begins to get very interesting." Goku then went along to comment, "Well, it looks like we'll be pairing off, Lord Beerus. We have to get rid of them now before more decide to show up. If that happens, then we won't have a chance." As Goku then went along to ask Merno, "Trying to even the odds, huh? What happened to finishing us by yourself?" With Merno having to respond, "Don't you worry about numbers, Saiyan. I figured we'd settle our business without the interruption of that miserable destroyer. Now, Saiyan, why don't you show me what you can really do with that power? You won't go far, I'll tell you that much, but it'll be amusing to see you try. You have this tendency to always get in the way of my plans, so I figured I'd correct this before you make things any worse for my plans. Now how about you show me? Go ahead. I'll let you make the first move if it means that much to you. Show me your flawed powers, Worm. I'm ready." And Goku does not hesitate, because as soon as he charges on in, he went along to shout, "With pleasure! Let's go!" And with Beerus having to stare off against another clone, Beerus then went along to comment, "If you're this powerful and as destructive as you say you are, then why don't you just end it all? Unless you're bluffing completely." And with Merno having to point behind him, he then went along to tell Beerus, "Oh, make no mistake about it, I could if I choose to, but where's the fun in just eradicating you all without seeing you suffer? Do you see that? While they're focused over there, it's time we settle the score so I can get back to what I was originally going to do. But just so you know, Destroyer, you won't make it out of this with your life. Not without your pet to save you this time." So Merno's condescending approach only then forces Beerus in firing off multiple ki blasts directly at him, with Beerus then having to respond, "Then far be it from me to keep you waiting." And as soon as Beerus fires off these attacks, what Merno winds up doing is he quickly avoids each and every single attack by bouncing off of them and responding, "How illogical of you, Beerus. This will not save you. You had your chance. Now it's my turn, and with Beerus having to be forced in defending himself, Merno then went along to punch Beerus and then responding, I can't wait to see the look on Whis' face when his precious destroyer dies before his eyes. As over back with Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku, Goku winds up uppercutting Merno in the face by telling him, there we go, take this, and with Merno stumbling back, he then responded, impressive for a mortal who only understands the basics of Ultra Instinct, but you'll have to do much better than that, Saiyan. And right before Merno further engages against Goku, he then takes a glance over by his side as he notices how Beerus and the other Merno were fighting. Merno then went along to comment, why isn't he finishing off Beerus already? He's toying with him, how annoying. Looks like the washed up god still has a bit of fight left within him. Well then, far be it from me to spice things up a little bit. As Merno then opens up a portal, he winds up punching right through and then having to comment, here's payback for getting in the way of my battle with the Saiyan. With of course Merno then having to interrupt Beerus' battle by punching him in the face, Goku winds up swooping on in and kicking Merno by then responding, you should keep your eyes on your opponent more often. Which when going back to Merno and Beerus, Beerus attempts to punch Merno with Merno grabbing onto Beerus' punch and responding, oh Beerus, how the mighty have fallen. Look at you. How could those runts allow you to still be a god is beyond me at this point, but don't you worry. You aren't the only one on the hit list. Champa is no exception. Neither is Belmon, Cedra, Jin, or any of the other failures. Does it bother you that you are helpless to stop me? I can feel it. I can sense your desperation. You know you have nothing. No chance, but yet you still refuse to quit. With Merno then having to elbow Beerus in the face and then punch him in the gut, Merno then continues, I think I had my fill. We've dragged this on long enough now. It's time we finish this, don't you think? And with Beerus clutching onto his stomach in absolute agony, he then went along to say to himself, this is crazy. I feel as if I'm fighting a brick wall. He has to have some kind of weakness, but where? How? And with Merno then grabbing Beerus by the throat, he then went along to tell him, you were never worthy. You've fallen from the highest mountain. This is where it ends. As Goku went along to quickly turn around, he then said to himself, Beerus' power just suddenly dropped. This is not good, as only then the Merno he was fighting latches onto Goku by having to get him in a chokehold. Merno then went along to tell Goku, oh no you don't, Saiyan, I know exactly what you were about to do, and it's not happening. You will watch before it's your turn, and with Goku struggling to escape, he then went along to shout, let go of me! Lord Beerus, no! And with Merno lifting Beerus by the throat, he then went along to tell him, I want you to remember that despite being a god, you were never my equal in battle. You gods should have been serving the angels instead. Although you may be the strongest among the other worms, you still never stood a chance against me. It was you who stood back and watched my destruction. It was the gods who laughed as my universe burned while theirs prospered. I still haven't forgotten any of it. And now, this is on your head. There was never a moment where you had any chance of winning. This is where you perish. But then, Beerus goes on to smile very condescendingly as he went along to ask, so, you still think I never had a chance, is that right? Well, and with Merno then having to ask, what could you possibly be laughing at? Wait. As he then slowly looks down while still clutching onto Beerus's neck, he then notices how Beerus's arm is placed right on Merno's stomach, with Beerus then having to tell Merno, you should have killed me when you had the chance. Hakai. As this was the exact moment that Beerus was looking for in getting the opportunity to have Merno right where he wanted him for the exact moment for a short time, Merno's body then begins to pulsate as Merno comments, no, no, my body! And with Beerus pushing away and backing up, Merno then asks, what have you done to me? Curse you, Beerus! With Beerus responding, bye-bye now, the Merno that's latched onto Goku's neck then slowly turns around and having to utter impossible, because Merno wasn't expecting for Beerus to do this, as of course the Merno that's disintegrating went along to comment, how dare you! You disgusting waste of life! This is not the end. I will kill you, you hear me? I will find you! Because this was something so unexpected that it gave Beerus leeway to actually finally connect a successful Hokai in getting rid of Merno for good, or at least a clone of him. And with Merno having to be shown disintegrating, he then went along to tell Beerus, this sin will not go unchecked, Beerus. Your faith in your own flawed power has betrayed you. No physical pain can harm me. I am forever and will forever remain. You've dug your own grave deeper through this act. When I awaken, when the original is awakened, you are doomed. As only then Beerus went along to respond, or so you say, Angel. When that time comes, I will deal with it and continue to rid your clones until there is not a single one left. Now disappear forever, as only then the Merno clone is Hokai'd into an oblivion, and with the counterpart Merno having to observe this by then throwing MUI Goku directly at Beerus, he then went along to shout, away with you, Saiyan! And with Goku bouncing back on his feet and standing next to Beerus, Merno then went along to comment, you disgusting god! You're quite the comedian if you truly believe you've got me all figured out, Beerus. Your lives are not worth living. Be that as it may, you take from me, and now I shall take from you. You are in no position to make the rules. I will not be destroyed by the likes of failures like you. This is where I take control of this game. Say your piece, because this is where I take your lives away. So what's most interesting is the clones seem to heavily imply that the original Merno is somewhere out there either within or outside of the existing multiverse, and he seems to be slumbering. There seems to be an act that is going on that until the original awakens, the clones are going to go on an absolute rampage, and with Merno then taking the approach and having to raise his power level up even more, he then went along to shout, I will show you power! As Merno then begins to activate a very familiar power, eerily similar to the one that Goku has right now, and the same power that Merno had displayed to Beerus before, with Beerus and Goku having to shield themselves, Beerus went along to tell Goku, how burnt out are you exactly, Goku? How long do you think you can hold this ultra instinct powers of yours? If there was ever a time for you to use it all, now's that time, with Goku responding, I'm not sure, but I still have some time. His power is massive. I don't think I've ever seen something like this before. That aura and that glow of his. Can it really be? As only then Merno reactivates the powers of Mastered Ultra Instinct, to where Merno then looks down and commenting, I will expunge you both forever. With Goku uttering, it's Ultra Instinct, as only then Merno in a fury looks down at both Beerus and Goku, Merno then went along to utter, the law is now broken. This is where you both die. I will take from you what you have taken from me. You have no chance. With Merno now having to use and activate the powers of Ultra Instinct, he only then went along to further inform Beerus and Goku by telling them, you worms are about to experience a tragedy that will shake the foundation of this universe to its core. No amount of power or collective effort will save you both from what's about to happen. You've made a fool of me for the last time. This time, there will be no assistance. There will be no mercy, and there will be no survivors. You've forced my hand into using the powers of Ultra Instinct, which already breaks the law of the angels according to the priest. This is not my full power. However, as this goes on, little by little, you will both experience the full force of what I can do. This is where it ends. And with Goku and Beerus looking on in shock, Goku went along to comment, whoa, his power, I can't even begin to measure it. I can't believe he can use Ultra Instinct like that, Lord Beerus. We need to act fast or else we're goners. With Beerus then responding, You've never seen this from him before, Saiyan? Damn it! Use everything you've got against him. It's now or never. And with Merno now beginning to shout and pointing down at Beerus and Goku, he only then continues, "I will purge you of everything. A worthless god such as you deserves to atone for his failure. The god of the 13th universe who once ruled would have laughed at what you've all become. I will liberate you from this title, and no matter what it is that you do or try to do, will fail. No amount of teamwork or power will save you from being removed from all of creation." And with Beerus staring back up, he then went along to tell Merno, "I don't care how strong you are, I will do to you what I did to the clone, and when I find the perfect time to strike, I will erase you from this world and rid you from my universe for good. Show me what you've got." And Merno then wastes little time in speed blitzing directly at them and then telling them, "Foolish Beerus, I will do more than just show you. I will make you suffer unlike any other." And with Goku having to comment, "Whoa, his speed! Lord Beerus, he's coming!" Merno then quickly moves on ahead to strike Beerus first by punching him in the stomach by telling him, "It's time to put the animal out of his misery for good this time." And as Merno begins to further demonstrate his speed in attacking Beerus from all sides, as Merno's attacking him, he then went along to ask, "Where did all of your confidence go, Destroyer? Is my speed too much for you? You had this punishment coming from the moment you allowed these mortals to breed." And with Merno continuously attacking Beerus, Beerus went along to say to himself, "My body is breaking. I can't feel my bones." As Merno then launches Beerus in the sky by then having to punch him in the face, he then went along to tell him, "A decent warm-up for a washed-up god such as yourself. Away with you. Don't miss me too much now. I'll get right back to you as soon as I am done ripping your pet mortal into little tiny pieces." With Merno then having to redirect his focus in attacking Master Ultra Instinct Goku, Merno backhands Goku by then telling him, "And now for you. We have some unfinished business to attend to, Saiyan. I haven't forgotten about you." With, of course, Beerus' body sent flying out into the distance, it is Whis that prevents Beerus from having to fly any further by teleporting behind Beerus and catching him by then telling Beerus, "Lord Beerus, I won't tell you what to do, but you must call for my action against him. He's reached a level far beyond you both, and you need my help." As Beerus went along to respond, "I said no! You will stay right here until I call for you. I will finish this on my own." So Beerus refuses to allow Whis to step on in because Beerus genuinely feels that this is his fight and that he has to finish this on his own. With Merno shown attacking Goku and getting the better of him, Whis only then continues, "Merno is displaying unusually extreme amounts of power. His Ultra Instinct far exceeds even Goku's. If Goku continues this, Merno will run him into the ground and his powers will be exhausted, Lord Beerus." With Beerus then having to respond, "Unless I absolutely call for you in a dire situation, do not interfere in this fight. Ultra Instinct or not, I will find a way. This will not stop me." As Whis went along to respond, "My lord, Merno is too dangerous to battle alone at this point. I need you to understand that he's hiding much more than he's letting on." And with Merno demonstrating his power, he went along to grab Goku by the throat and asking him, "Did you truly think your Ultra Instinct was superior to mine, Worm?" With Goku having to ask, "How are you this strong?" With Merno then slamming Goku over and over onto the ground, he then went along to tell him, "Don't you worry, Saiyan. It was as I told you from the very beginning. This is my game, and I make the rules. Down you go, Saiyan, down, 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 down." As he keeps slamming Goku over and over again, Beerus with all of his might is trying to step forward, with Whis having to tell him, "Please, my lord, allow for my aid in this." But that's when Beerus cuts him off and responding, "I said no, Whis. I don't care what he has or what he's hiding. This is my battle." As Whis then tries to desperately talk some sense into Beerus, he then went along to tell him, "Regardless if this is your battle to wage or not, if he is allowed to continue his rampage, then there will be no means of stopping him. My brother always possessed many abilities and techniques that placed him far above the other angels, which means it is too dangerous to keep him around, Lord Beerus. He isn't your standard fighter. He's using you and Goku for a greater agenda. There is no telling what he can do, and he is obviously holding back tremendous amounts of power. He is the first angel since his time to break our sacred law, as I am sure the Grand Priest has also felt the surge of power. But with his attention focused in training Vegeta, I am the only one that can help. You can barely stand on your own 2 feet, my lord. Please call for my assistance against him. And with Beerus trying to do everything he could to stand back up, he then went along to comment, "This bastard was stringing me along this entire time. I was lucky to have Hokai'd one of them because it was the only opening I had. He knows of it now. He won't make that same mistake the second time around," with Whis having to respond, "I can also feel Goku's power starting to slip away. If we don't act now, then he will surely lose control of Ultra Instinct and Merno would find his opening," as of course Goku is shown doing everything he can to try to attempt to punch Merno, with Merno having to sidestep out of the way in attacking Goku. Beerus then annoyingly went along to comment, "Ultra Instinct, a power that was nearly mine, now used against me. How did I reach this power before? How did the Saiyan do it? I have to find a way. This will not be the end of me. I refuse to bow to him." As Whis went along to respond, "You were in a different place, my lord. Your mind and body adapted differently. I ask of you to call for me in this fight. Time is running out for you both." So Beerus refuses to allow Whis to interject only because Beerus's pride is beginning to manifest itself on the surface, as Beerus believes that this is his fight to finish and his battle alone, and is not only getting agitated at the idea that he really can't do anything to stop Merno, but as Merno is shown continuously attacking Goku, he then went along to ask him, "What's wrong, mortal? Not winning as easily as you thought? Is it because you're starting to see the depths of my power, or is it because you've accepted that no matter what you do, you could never destroy what I am?" With Goku having to comment, "You haven't beaten me yet, Merno. I won't lose." With Merno responding, "Then I'll just beat you into submission instead." And with Goku having to dodge right on the spot, he then responded, "No, you won't. I'm not giving up without putting up a fight." And with Beerus trying to do everything he could to re-enter this battle, he then went along to shout, "Damn it! Why am I so damaged? I refuse to let this be the end. I cannot stand for this. Ultra Instinct or not, I don't care what he does. I will not allow this to be the end of me." And that's when Beerus' power begins to surge, because he's tapping deeper within himself to use every ounce of whatever power he has left to fight back against Merno. We only then go back to the Grand Priest, who is still continuously training Vegeta, as the Grand Priest then senses how Merno had now broken the law, with the Grand Priest then having to comment, "It was just as I had feared. My action will be needed shortly if they cannot finish what has already been started on the Destroyer's planet. I need you to get up and try again, Vegeta. This power cannot be used unless adjusted to its pressure." And with Vegeta shown on his knees, battered and damaged, he then went along to comment, Why does it always escape me? I can't feel my body. I feel as if my bones are going to shatter." With the Grand Priest then telling him, "You've learned of the ability I had taught you, along with mastering your blue evolution. However, to transcend this current power, you will have to engage with me further to harness it. You had a small taste of what it felt like. Now continue to push." And with Vegeta shown clearly battered, bloody, and bruised, he only then responds, "What do I need to do in order to keep it from leaving me? Why is this so much more important than anything else you've shown me? Unless there is more to what you're showing me." As the Grand Priest responds, "It is important because it is an elite level of power that calls for it to be used if I am not able to aid you in battle. Once we are finished here, I will head back and destroy the clone myself." Only because he had chosen to break the law of our race and defy the law of the great Omni Kings. "My actions are needed, but not without teaching you. Now get up." So clearly the Grand Priest is not finished training Vegeta, as we only then go back to Goku, who is shown hitting the ground below. He only then went along to say to himself, "Damn, this guy How does he keep it up like this? I can't afford to lose this power. What choice do I even have? Because at this point, Goku is now beginning to lose tremendous amounts of power at a very alarming rate, and with Merno looking down on him, he then went along to comment, "To think your kind was allowed to breed. I am going to finish what I started when I first laid eyes on you, Saiyan. You've shown me that there is no saving you. You would have made for great rulers of a new multiverse." And with Beerus trying to sneak attack Merno, Merno instantly vanishes and having to then tell Beerus, Now, Beerus, I said I would get back to you as soon as I was done taming your pet. As he then swoops on in and punching Beerus in the gut, he then continues, "You will listen like a good little pawn and wait your turn." And with Goku shown struggling to sit up, he then comments, "Beerus, no! You can't do it alone! He's too much!" As Merno then proceeds to kick Goku right in the face and then telling him, "I didn't ask for your input, Saiyan." And with Goku crashing right down next to Beerus, Merno then continues, "Never in my lifetime would I ever expect to see a mortal and a destroyer work alongside like this. This entire multiverse is ass backwards, with gods content and mortals reaching levels that rival them. It is one of the many reasons why I must erase everything and start over." And with Goku shown powering out of Ultra Instinct back down to his base form, Merno then went along to continue, and there it goes. It was only a matter of time before you lost it. Can't say that I'm surprised. A mortal such as yourself could never understand the depths of a power such as Ultra Instinct. And as Merno then grabs Goku by the hair and lifting him up above, he then continues, "You've lived a long enough life, and it's time to liberate you from this world. But before I end you, I want you to remember something, mortal. You never stood a chance. I've learned all that I needed from you and your kind. You are of no use to me anymore. Goodbye, Saiyan." And what Merno proceeds to do is snap Goku's neck right in front of Beerus, as he then proceeded to throw Goku's carcass down onto the ground. Merno then redirects his attention directly at Beerus and then telling him, "That's one less worm to stand in my way of my plans. He had this coming, and now, God of Destruction, it's time that you join him in the afterlife. I still haven't forgotten. Now, where were we?" Because this is bad, and Merno is now looking to target and fully destroy Beerus after going out of his way to make sure that Goku is now permanently dead, with both Whis and Beerus having to be in utter shock following the events of Merno having to kill Goku. As of course they look on, Beerus went along to comment, He killed him. He truly took the Saiyan's life. No, son. Son Goku," with Whis having to comment, "He actually went through with taking Goku's life. It's what I feared would happen." And with Merno having to be shown very aggressive, he then went along to shout, "And that's one less worthless pest to deal with. What's this? Is that distress and concern I sense from you, Destroyer? And you, Whis, to think that gods would have this much care for mortal life disgusts me. And now that he's finally out the way, it's time I send you to the same place I sent this Saiyan, Beerus. Are you now beginning to understand the difference in our power? You're quite the comedian if you believe there is anything you could do that will change the outcome of this next engagement. I don't need Ultra Instinct to kill you. You were beaten long ago. I'm going to enjoy kicking your teeth down your throat before blasting you into pieces. Oh, and don't worry, Whis. I haven't forgotten about you either." And with Beerus having to be shown powering up, he then went along to charge at Merno by telling him, "I've had enough of your games!" But then that's when Merno swipes his fingers down and then having to respond, "Know your place, Destroyer. Down goes the cat." And with Beerus's body having to be shown hitting the ground due to Merno's gravity force, at this point there's not really much Beerus can do in his efforts to stand up against Merno. And with Beerus having to be shown remaining in place, Merno so casually is beginning to walk up to him as he went along to comment, "I'm flabbergasted, Beerus. You are nowhere near my feats of strength, yet you continue to defy the odds and try anyway. and with Merno shown stomping down on Beerus' spine, he then continues, "I wonder how much more your body can handle before your bones begin to crack under the pressure of a power far beyond yours." So at this point, Merno is essentially torturing Beerus by not only having to hold him in place, but also adding insult to injury by having to demean his power, and with Whis looking on, he then went along to say to himself, "I cannot stand by and watch this unfold. It's only been roughly 30 seconds since Goku's death, which means there is still time to change things as it was during Gogeta and Broly's battle on Vampa against him. If I am not permitted by Lord Beerus to intervene directly, then perhaps I could be of use through another means. It's the only other way," and with Whis shown spawning his staff, he then continues, "If I reverse time quick enough, it'll undo the events of Merno killing Goku, and it would at least give Lord Beerus and Goku another chance to work together in order to destroy this clone. Without my direct influence, this is the best I can do until I am permitted by Lord Beerus to further be of any assistance to him. It's now or never," as meanwhile Merno was shown stomping down on Beerus over and over and over again, Merno then went along to continue, "How many stomps do you think your spine can take before snapping in two? Come on, mighty god, where did all of that confidence go? Don't tell me you've lost all sense of hope, have you?" And with Whis shown having to tap his scepter once, it was at that moment where Merno began to realize exactly what Whis was up to, because from there, he was able to pick up at the fact that Whis was about to reverse time, as he went along to then comment, "The staff. Oh no, you don't," as Merno then wastes little time in dashing right in and swiping away Whis' staff. He then went along to tell him, "There will be no time reversing on my watch this time, Whis. I knew you'd do this." And with Merno getting face to face with his brother, he then continues, "Did you really think I would allow you to ruin my plans again as you had done before? You're going to wait your turn. What's wrong? Surprised at my speed? I've always been faster and stronger than you. This shouldn't be a shock to you," as only then, Beerus winds up getting up and charging directly at Merno by shouting his name. What Merno winds up doing is swiping away Beerus by having to whack him with Whis' staff, as he went along to tell Beerus, "I said away with you." And this causes Beerus to go flying out into the distance, with Beerus having to say to himself, I have nothing left." And as he crashes, ironically enough, right next to Goku's body, Merno winds up powering back out of Ultra Instinct and further addressing his brother by telling him, "It's interesting how Father allowed you and the others to supersede my position. I've always been ahead of the pack, yet I was erased and you all remained. You've done enough to foil my plans, and I will not allow you to stand in my way again." And with Merno then having to take a closer look at Whis' staff, he then continues, "The Staff of the Angels. I had one of these before it was ripped away from me. I guess now I'll claim yours as my own. You never needed this anyway." And with Whis having to clench his fist, he then responded, "No matter what happens, I will not allow you to continue your acts of defiance against the rules of the Angels and the Omni King. I will do what I must to protect what was given to me, even if it means battling against you. My orders by the Grand Priest shall remain." And with Merno having to point Whis' staff back at him, he then went along to respond, "And what exactly are you going to do to stop me, Whis? You're bound by the pathetic law of the Angels when I just went against and broke them. Until you are given the act of stepping into this battle by Beerus, you will remain in your place. And even if you try something, I will not hesitate then to smash you into pieces. You think you've got me all figured out? Once my original body is formed and the spirit of my power is restored, I will destroy every trace of you and our father. You dug your own grave against me when you decided to watch as my universe and my throne burned before everyone's eyes." So clearly Merno still has a vendetta and grudge not only towards his father and the Omni Kings, but also his brother Whis along with the other angels, and with Beerus having to look on over and noticing Goku's body, Beerus went along to say to himself, "Goku, his body. Damn you, Goku, I told you this was my fight. Why didn't you listen to me?" And with Beerus trying to stand back up, he then continues, "To think that a destroyer would ever sympathize with a mortal would be considered outrageous among the gods, but you were different. You never saw me as your enemy, but simply wanted to prove yourself to me with your power. It never was personal with you, as Beerus then recalls the events leading from Battle of Gods all the way up until the Tournament of Power. Beerus then continues, "From the moment I met you, I knew there was something special about you. Whether that was your stupidity or your thriving hunger to get stronger. You've never feared me, but have always respected me, and even fought your heart out to preserve not just your life, but mine as well. And although you defied my orders to intervene in this battle, you still did anyway, to work with me, not as a protector, but as an ally, something I've never had come from a mortal before." And with Beerus' energy then beginning to glow, Beerus then continues, "And what's more is you never offered your hand in rebellion, but only through friendship." As out of nowhere, Beerus then erupts with a massive power that only then causes not only Whis, but for Merno to also turn around and putting this into question by asking, "What's this power?" As Whis went along to comment, "Could it be? Lord Beerus, he's done it. This power, it's..." As Merno then chimes in, "No, not him too, but how? Ultra Instinct." As only then we get to lo and behold mastered Ultra Instinct Beerus, to where, keep in mind, it was alluded from the beginning that Beerus at some point was in fact able to use this power, but was never actually able to reach this level of power since. And with Beerus having to then stare Merno down with a very intense look on his face, Merno then went along to grin and responding, "Well, well, a little late to the party, don't you think? And here I was beginning to doubt that you had anything left in the tank, but it appears as though you still have some left in you. This should be very amusing. And what makes you think this power of yours could be of any use to destroy mine? Have you forgotten that I have mastered this power? You still have no chance of winning. But I do love a dramatic ending. So go on, Destroyer. Give it all you've got, because this will be the last time you do. And watch as I make another example out of you." But then, Whis went along to chime in telling Merno, "Well, it appears there is still hope after all. Far be it from me to stop you from having your fun, but before you do so, I believe you have something that rightfully belongs to me and not you. Allow me to assist you with that." With Whis having to be shown grabbing back onto his staff, with Merno turning around, Whis went along to then tell him, "It appears as though you have bigger problems to deal with outside of me now, Merno. You might want to pay attention," as only then, out of nowhere, Beerus dashes on in delivering a thunderous shot to Merno, in which causes Merno to go flying out into the distance. And with Whis having to acknowledge Beerus, Beerus then went along ahead to actively respond to Whis by telling him, "Whis, wait for my signal. When I do, you know what must be done." And with Whis looking down smiling, he then responds, "I knew you had it in you to tap into this power once again. I couldn't be any more proud of you, my lord. You finally did it, but time is not on our side. Do what you must, and if it calls for it, my service will be right here waiting for you. It hasn't been 3 full minutes since Goku's death either, which means we only have roughly around 70 seconds until my abilities can no longer be used." And with Beerus acknowledging this and then getting into fighting position, out of nowhere, Merno then rises back up through the smoke, also wielding Ultra Instinct, very angry mind you, as he went along to shout at Beerus by telling him, "One lucky shot does not change the outcome of this battle, but if that's the way you want to play, then far be it from me to keep you waiting then." Because this is it, Merno is now looking to finally finish off the God of Destruction just as he did with Goku, and with Merno's attention now having to be fully focused on Beerus, he further went along to address Beerus by telling him, "So you've obtained Ultra Instinct, so what? You think this gives you power over me, Destroyer? Not a chance. You are next to join the Saiyan in the afterlife." And with Beerus getting into fighting position, he went along to then tell Whis, "Whis, on my signal, either he dies or the opportunity will be lost for good. Angel or not, he dies here. Do as I order you to, and don't take your eyes off him. This is our only chance, because Beerus seems to have a plan here, and he's willing to tell Whis and give him the order once he's ready to do so, but with Merno not wasting any time and having to speed blitz right towards Beerus, he then went along to tell him, let me show you the difference in our power. And with Merno shown attacking Beerus with Beerus on the defensive, it's a battle of Ultra Instinct deities, with of course Merno shown having the upper hand, and as Merno continues his attack, he went along to then continue by telling Beerus, there is no amount of training or power increases that you can manage to obtain that will save you from the onslaught that's coming. As of course Merno winds up ducking under Beerus's punch, he then continues, especially once the original is complete. As he then follows by punching Beerus in the face, Merno keeps reassuring Beerus that as soon as the original awakens and his power is then restored to him, then there is absolutely nothing that anyone including Beerus is going to do to stop him. And with Whis having to turn slightly in looking behind him, he then notices Goku's carcass on the floor as he went along to say to himself, there is still time. Seeing how easily Merno was able to tear into Goku's powers leaves me to believe that the Saiyan is still not fully ready to engage him even with Ultra Instinct. But there is still hope, and with Merno further engaging against Beerus, Merno further went along to then ask Beerus, is guarding yourself from me going to be the only thing you do in this battle? Or is it because you're beginning to now see that even with Ultra Instinct, my power still dwarfs yours, Destroyer? And as Beerus is shown guarding himself, he went along to then look at Whis and telling him, Whis, not yet. Keep your eyes on his movements. You're the only one who can follow them. He'll do what he did before if it's done now. So wait, if my prediction is true, then we found our chance. And with Beerus then retaliating by then punching Merno in the face, he quickly went along to then tell Merno, you disrespected my title as Destroyer for the last time. A fallen angel deserves nothing less than to be erased forever. And just like your clone before, I will do it again. And with Beerus shown having to throw a left hook in Merno having to grab onto it, Merno then condescendingly went along to tell Beerus, is that what you believe, Beerus? As if I would ever allow you to do what you did again. Though, I wouldn't expect for such power to be comprehended by a disgrace such as you. Do you still think I'm bluffing, Destroyer? You were only kept around for my entertainment. I could have ended your life long ago. And if you further want proof of this, allow me to show you then. As seconds later, what Merno winds up doing is driving his left hand right through Beerus's chest and having to impale him, with Merno having to comment, ta-da! The grand finale before we close the curtains for good. And this shocks everyone, including Whis, who went along to shout, Lord Beerus! With, of course, Merno's arm having to be shown driven right through Beerus's chest, Beerus, who is in utter agony, went along to utter, this power, I... no... impossible. And with Merno having to look back up at Beerus with a bloodthirsty look on his face, he then went along to ask him, does it hurt, God? Your blood smells delicious. This was the feeling I had to endure when you all turned your backs to me and watched me suffer by the hands of that little Omni rat. So to the surprise of everyone, Merno wasn't in fact bluffing when he had told Beerus that he could have ended his life long ago but had simply kept Beerus around just for purely entertainment purposes. And with Beerus having to be shown suffering, he then went along to say to himself, if this fails, then the seventh is finished. I have his attention. He's completely unaware of Whis. As Beerus then went along to tell Merno, the hell with you. You were never good enough to be kept around anyway. And with Merno having to get really annoyed, he then went along to tell Beerus, but the difference here is that I will live and you will not. That face of yours is really starting to bother me. What do you say we take it off that head of yours, shall we? You won't feel a thing, I promise. And right before Merno proceeds to knock Beerus' head off, Beerus then went along to turn his attention to Whis and having to tell him, Whis! Now! And that's when Whis gets the order from Beerus in using his scepter to then reverse time, as Whis went along to then comment, just in time. Back we go, and with Whis tapping his scepter down, time is then reversed, because this was Beerus's plan from the get-go, and with everything having to now be reversed, we then observe how Merno is back down on the ground, and with Merno having to question this, he went along to comment, the warping of space and time. I'm back on the ground. Which means, No! And as Merno then looks at his hands, he then continues, he did it again! The Destroyer's blood is gone! That worm reversed time in bringing me back here! But why this point? I was baited, and with Merno looking down and noticing how both Goku and Beerus are still alive, Merno then went along to continue, the Saiyan's alive! Of course! The Destroyer used me to get my attention off my brother for him to reverse time to this point. And with Merno shown getting absolutely infuriated, he then went along to comment, "You have crossed me for the last time, Whis. You vermin have lived on long enough. I will not allow what happened on that trash planet Vampa to happen again to me here. I am going to finish this once and for all. And when I'm done, there will be no more resurrections." And with Goku shown sitting back up, he then went along to utter, "What? What just happened? Damn him. He's too strong." And with Merno sticking his hand out and generating a blast, he then went along to tell them, "And this is where the two of you die. For good this time. I know of Whis's ability to reverse time. I also know of how long it would take for him to do it again. And there's nothing that will save you from what's about to happen. Now die!" Because this was the moment that Merno was looking to finally have in ending both Beerus and Goku, until out of nowhere, Whis winds up uppercutting Merno so hard in the face that the sheer impact alone causes Merno to go flying off of Beerus's planet and onto a lingering moon, with Whis having to tell him, "The order was made. You will not go any further." And with Merno's body shown flying into orbit, Whis had made the clutch to step in just in time, right before Merno had killed off Beerus and Goku. And with Whis having to look down in acknowledging both Beerus and Goku, he went along to then tell them, "I need you both to get up. That attack won't slow Merno down. You are lucky to be alive, Goku. Lord Beerus has called for my actions to be used, and I will hereby aid you both in this battle. I am sure you are well aware that your Ultra Instinct power is no longer with you, Lord Beerus, but in order for us to make sure that this is over, I need you both to stand back up and continue." And with Goku shown struggling to stand back up, Whis then continues, "My ability to reverse time has worn off, and I am unable to use it for a while, so do yourself a favor, the both of you, and try not to get yourselves killed during this fight." With Goku having to respond, "Thanks, Whis. I guess I'll try not to." And with Whis shown picking Beerus up, he then continues, "You've taken quite the punishment, my lord. And although your body may be damaged, I need you to stand back up and continue." With Beerus then having to comment, "That Ultra Instinct power wore me down. He's stronger than what we're giving him credit for." And with Whis getting into fighting position, he then continues, "No matter what happens, this universe must be protected. I will hereby fight alongside you as the laws have been broken. I will deal with the ramifications alongside the Grand Priest later." So, Whis had been given the order by Beerus to finally intervene just in time to not only save himself but to also save Goku, and with Whis having to prepare himself, he then went along to tell Beerus and Goku, "He is getting far too dangerous by the minute. And I'm afraid if what he is saying about his original is true, then we may be in bigger trouble than what's about to happen here. Now's not the time for us to lose track of things. I can feel his energy boiling." As over back on the moon in which Merno was sent to, he winds up powering up so much that the sheer power of Merno's energy completely tears into the moon, with Merno having to be absolutely enraged by what just happened as he went along to shout, "Whis!" And Merno is pissed because he was not expecting for his brother to intervene, and with both Goku and Beerus shown in fighting position, Goku went along to comment, "This is nuts. It's like he wants to use his full power, but he's hesitant. Why is that? What's his goal here?" As Beerus went along to reply, "It's to feed the original as much knowledge on each universe as he could, and if he kills us along the way, then it's just a small prize for his efforts in doing so. Do what you must, but stay out of my way, Saiyan." As over back with the Grand Priest, Vegeta continues his training along with the priest as the Grand Priest went along to comment, "Now try it again, Vegeta." And with Vegeta trying to attempt to do what the Grand Priest had just told him, there is a massive shadow that then overtakes the Grand Priest along with the ground on the floor, and with the Grand Priest having to then look up, he quickly went along to then comment, "Merge your mind along with this power in order to keep it from controlling you. And if you fail, then get up and try it again. This power comes from your ancestors, does it not?" So clearly there is an evolutionary process that is beginning to take place with Vegeta, but it seems as though Vegeta can't seem to get this right, as of course the Grand Priest had ordered him to do it again. And as Vegeta does so, the Grand Priest then went along to tell him, "Good. Now merge these powers together in becoming one with your mind and body. Transform using your strongest form. Super Saiyan Blue Evolution, as you call it." But then suddenly the Grand Priest begins to pick up on an unusual signal as he went along to then say to himself, "This power. Whis was called into action. The laws have now been broken by two. My presence is needed as soon as this has been fully completed." As we then go back to Beerus's planet, Merno then points down in a fit of anger while wielding Ultra Instinct and having to cry out, "I am going to atomize you all, especially you, Whis." And with Merno charging right in and punching both Beerus and Goku away, he then went along to comment, "I'll deal with you roaches later. Away with you both." And with Goku and Beerus sent flying out into the distance, this just now leaves Whis and Merno by themselves, as Merno went along to sadistically smile by looking behind him and commenting, "Now that those two are out of the way, I've been counting down the days where I'd finally get to do what I'm about to do to you, Whis. I'm going to savor every moment of it. I wanted to wait until my original body had been restored, but I've decided to at least spill one angel's blood today, and that angel will be you. Will I hold back, or will I massacre you? I guess we'll have to wait and see what the cards hold. Now let us begin." And with Merno having to bounce back following Whis' attack, Merno then went along to address Whis by telling him, "I've longed for the day where I would see you beg for your life beneath my feet as I once begged for mine before everything was taken from me. This will not end in your favor, Whis." And with Whis getting into fighting position, he then went along to respond, "And as long as I am instructed on being the governing angel of the seventh universe, then I will do everything in my power to see this battle through, Merno. I didn't want this to happen, brother, but I am left with no other choice." And with both angels shown directly charging at each other, Merno then went along to tell Whis, "Then far be it from me to rip you away from that position." And as the angels clash with both Beerus and Goku staring back up, Beerus went along to utter, "Incredible. Never in my time would I ever dream to witness an angel battle against another angel in a fight. This is the first time I've ever seen Whis this serious in a battle before. These angels are unlike anything I've ever witnessed before, but there seems to be something about Merno that gives him the edge here. I hope you destroy him once and for all, Whis." As Goku went along to utter, "Their movements are unreal. I can barely even keep up with them. The impact of each attack is making my body shake." And as Merno was shown attacking Whis with Whis having to do his best in deflecting, Merno then went along to ask him, "What's wrong, brother? You seem to be struggling a bit. Aren't you one of Father's favorites? Either I'm much stronger than I give myself credit for, or you've become unbelievably weaker." And with Merno having to be shown throwing punch after punch with Whis doing everything he could to dodge them, Merno then continues, "As if avoiding my attacks is going to make a difference. Did you already forget who you're fighting here? If you believe you have any chance of destroying me," as Merno then followed up by giving Whis a thunderous right haymaker, he then continues, "then allow me to remind you on why you're wrong." But Whis then quickly turns the tides by having to elbow Merno in the face by responding, "We'll see about that. Don't assume that one lucky shot will seal your victory in this battle." And with Merno stumbling back and holding onto his mouth, he then went along to respond, "That wasn't half bad, Whis. But here I thought you'd hit me a lot harder. Weak. Like you've always been. It amazes me how you were selected to remain while my universe crumbled under the delusion of the Omni King. Pathetic." And with Merno smirking, he then continues, "Come on, Whis. The laws are already broken. So what's stopping you? I want to see the full extent of your power, not just a small portion of it. It's do or die. The choice is yours. And with Whis shown charging on in, he then went along to tell his brother, you won't be so lucky to survive when your name is called by the Grand Minister and the Omni Kings. And until then, I will do my duties to see this fight through. With Merno responding, we'll see about that. And with Whis attempting to punch Merno with Merno having to duck under, Merno then went along to tell his brother, I hope you know, Whis, that what you see and what you're currently experiencing is only but a small portion of my true power. And with Merno then having to be shown punching Whis in the gut, he then continues, nothing can prepare you for when my original body and power is restored to its former glory. But then, Whis quickly counters by having to double axe handle Merno across the back by asking him, then why are you holding back? And with Merno landing on his feet and having to look back up, he then continues, because what good would this game be if I can't hear you squirm like the animals you all are, traitor? But then, unbeknownst to Merno, as of course Merno has his sights locked on Whis, Beerus then comes swooping on in as he then went along to tell Merno, don't assume that I'm out of this battle just yet, Merno. You've got bigger problems to deal with now that you're outnumbered 3-1 in this battle, so you're screwed. With Merno then having to ask, you think numbers will help you here, Destroyer? With Merno then having to use the force of gravity on his side by flicking his fingers down and continuing, down with you, animal. If it were not for Whis, you and that Saiyan would have been dead by now. Once I'm done ripping Whis apart, just know that you're next. And with Whis then having to spawn his staff, he then went along to tell Merno, if you honestly believe that this is going to be as easy as you assume it will be, then make your move. But just know that I will take any measure to see this through. Since your time as Angel of the 13th Universe, I've improved, both as a guardian and as a warrior. You may have been the strongest of our race, but your time was over and done with a long time ago. As of course Whis then prepares, Merno then continues to stare back up with a very sinister smile on his face and continuing, well, I'm glad that your stupid stick gave you the confidence needed to talk back to me, but you'll soon see. I'm only just getting started with you all, and with Merno having to leap back up, he then continues, now let's just see what you can do. With pleasure, Whis utters, as he went along to smack Merno across the face with his staff, and what Whis attempted to do was further use this staff as a means of attacking Merno, but with Merno shown having to duck and dodge, he then went along to tell Whis, don't gas yourself up too much now, Whis. What happened? Not hitting me as easily as you thought? Is it because I've increased my speed, or, as he went along to then grab the staff, he then continues, is it because you're slowly losing hope? And with Merno then shown kicking Whis into the distance by then having to steal his staff, he then went along to tell him, I'll take this, thank you very much, you won't be needing it anymore anyway. Now away with you! And with mastered Ultra Instinct Goku attempting to make his presence known by teleporting behind Merno, Merno then went along to utter, oh look who's back for more. Don't worry, Saiyan, as of course he then proceeded to smack Goku with the staff, he then continues, I haven't forgotten about you. You will wait your turn, and with Goku being smited away, Merno then went along to further point his staff at everyone by then telling them, I will admit this staff here had caused quite the trouble for me. It's been annoying me ever since you decided to reverse time to help that savage Broly along with the Saiyan's fusion on planet Vampa. It would be a while before a new one is formed, so I think it's time we take care of this one, shall we? So not only was Merno able to handle both Beerus and Goku, but he was also able to knock Whis away, steal his staff, as he then went along ahead to snap Whis' staff across his knee by then uttering, this is more like it. And with Whis noticing this and having to fire multiple shots at Merno, Whis then went along to shout, you should keep your eyes on your target. As all of the attacks then made contact, what Merno winded up doing was he quickly vanished by using one of his portals and then having to reappear behind Whis and then telling him, oh, don't you worry about what I'm doing. You should worry more about keeping your head. As Merno then went along to try and kick Whis' head off, he then uttered, gotcha, what? Because of course Whis was able to dodge, but that didn't stop Merno because Merno then went along to latch onto Whis' hair and then telling him, lucky dodge. Now let's just see if you can manage to avoid this one. As of course, Merno went along ahead to charge right down on the ground by pulling Whis by the hair and asking him, what's wrong, brother? Having trouble? As he then slams Whis' skull down on the ground, he then continues, to the ground with you, traitor. Does it hurt? This is only but a grain of sand compared to what I felt when you all had turned your backs to me when I needed you all the most. I am going to make you suffer. And right before Merno went along to strike Whis on the floor, Whis actually managed to move out of the way quick enough and teleporting behind Merno, but the second Whis actually attempted to hit Merno, Merno actually quickly countered by grabbing onto Whis's punch and then uttering, "Oh no you don't. These won't work on me anymore." As he once again punched Whis away, Merno then went along to tell him, "It was like I had told you. You have no chance of surviving this battle. And now that your staff is broken, there will be no more time reversals." And as Whis manages to quickly bounce back and landing on his feet, he then uttered, "Damn it. He's tougher than I expected him to be. But he also seems to be holding back." And with Merno then looking to end everything by raising his hand up in the air, he then went along to tell his brother, "And now this is where the game ends, Whis. Good luck trying to pull away from this one. It's over, fool." But then, a mysterious voice went along to then tell Merno, "His blood is to be spilled by my hands, clone." And Merno is shook because he knows exactly what this voice is, as he went along to utter that voice. That could only mean, and Whis notices this because Murno's entire demeanor had changed, with Whis having to comment, "He stopped? What just happened? He looks as if he's seen a ghost. Why is his body suddenly trembling?" As the voice then continues, "The time to purge creation has dawned. Do not forget why you're there." As Merno utters, "Yes, but of course, the great harvest." As he then went along to look at his hands, he then continues, "I can feel it. The most highest of powers. I can feel your presence, yes. The vessel has been restored along with its original power." As the voice then continues, "Finish what is left and return to me at once. The great merger has begun." And with Merno having to stare terrifyingly up at the sky, he then went along to comment, "The hour of judgment is here. The great apocalypse has finally begun. Yes, I will finish what remains and then I will return for the great merger. The time has come." Merno then further went along to stare back up at the sky as he went along to comment, "So it looks like it's finally time. I've longed for this. Unless something has changed, it looks as if everything fell right into place. I've longed for this day ever since my universe's destruction by the hands of that ridiculous Omni-King. I was lucky to have survived, and now, the hour of retribution is almost here. They will all soon understand and feel my pain." And with Merno then having to redirect his focus back at Goku, Beerus, and Whis, he then went along to ask, "Why the awkward faces? You are all screwed. My original body is complete, and my power is nearing its former glory and beyond, which means you're all on borrowed time. I enjoyed playing with my food, but the time to finally eat is very near. I learned so much about you all. It paved the way for my resurrection," with Goku then having to comment, "So that's what happened. Your original form is what spoke out to you. It doesn't have to be this way. You could do so much more than go through with this. You know you won't make it out of this alive by going up against the three of us, so give up." And with Whis, Beerus, and Goku standing side by side, Merno then went along to ask them, "You do know that if it weren't for Whis turning back time that you'd all be dead right now, but it doesn't matter anymore. I got what I wanted. I don't have a whole lot of time left, so what do you say we wrap this up then? I want to see what more I can get out of you before the real fun begins. Now, who wants to be the first to get crushed?" As we then go back to Vegeta and the Grand Priest, Vegeta is shown on the floor, battered, bloody, bruised, and tired as he went along to utter, "I did it. I can't feel anything anymore. My body is broken. It's done. The merger is finally done. I never want to experience anything like that again. Who would have thought by combining this power would push me this much? I feel as if I'm dying. Every part of me hurts. This pain, it's echoing all over my body, but this portion is done. But I know there's still more to do. I swear when I get my hands on Merno, I'm going to rip him to pieces. So it's only a matter of time. And when I find him, He will pay. So Vegeta clearly had underwent such a torturous training session with the Grand Priest to where he even admits that he feels as if he's dying. His bones feel as if they're breaking. His body had looked like it went through a meat grinder. So Vegeta now has just finished one part of his training as he then went along to continue. And after it's all said and done, I will be the strongest once again and surpass Kakarot beyond comprehension. And with the Grand Priest stepping forward, he further went along to address Vegeta by telling him, "Very good, Vegeta, you've successfully combined your ancient ancestors' power with the current god powers you possess. Although I fear that you may not be able to fully maintain such power for a long time, this will be another process that we are going to soon correct. This power should be enough to hold off much longer than your previous transformation, but we aren't done." As the Grand Priest then went along to spawn his staff, he then continues, "You are only starting to scratch the surface of true power. There is still much for you to learn." And with the Grand Priest healing Vegeta, he then continued, "We are going to start from the top. The trick behind what Merno is doing is he is purposely suppressing himself to give off the illusion that he's weak, but he is not. He is only doing this to drag whatever he wants out of you before he finishes them." With Vegeta having to ask, "So, I'm going to need more than what I've acquired in order to fully destroy him," with the priest responding, "Much more." Now, from the top, Vegeta, as we then go back to Merno, who is shown still taunting everyone, he then went along to ask, "What say you, Destroyer? I know your ego is just begging for you to jump in and do something about me stabbing you through the chest. Will it be you?" And Beerus actually falls for the bait as he went along to dash on in and having to tell Merno, "I swear on my honor as a god of destruction, I am going to rip you apart for making a fool out of me." But Merno easily kicks Beerus away and then having to tell him, "Oh really? Not with that pathetic power you won't." But that's when Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku winds up teleporting behind Merno, as Merno went along to acknowledge this by commenting, "Oh, and you, Saiyan, you've been an annoying factor ever since I laid my eyes on you. The little ant who could. Well, you can't, and you won't." As he then so casually uppercuts Goku in the face by then telling him, "You are not worthy either," Merno then observes how his brother Whis once again jumps on in as he went along to acknowledge his brother by commenting, "You, on the other hand, you are currently on the top of my list." And with the two having to be shown dashing towards each other, Merno then went along to continue, "I want you to feel the pain I felt after you turned your back to me before I rid you from your existence." And with Whis shown attacking, he then went along to respond, "It won't be that easy, Merno, and even if I fail, the Grand Priest will see to it that you pay for everything you've done." And with Merno shown fighting back, he then went along to continue, "Leaving it to Father now, are we? Once he sees what I've done to you, he's next." As Merno winds up punching Whis in the face, he then continues, "You betrayed your own kind, Whis. You must be judged. You must be punished. And I will take everything from you, coward." And as soon as Merno winds up throwing Whis out into the distance, both Goku and Beerus wind up double teaming and charging directly at Merno as Goku went along to shout, "Oh no you don't, Merno," with Beerus then having to utter, "You're the one who will be punished." To where you can feel the level of tension here, because Beerus, Goku, Whis, they're all trying to do everything in their ability to make sure that Merno is put in his place. But right before both Goku and Beerus make contact, Merno winds up opening a portal and then having to flee, with Beerus having to cry out, "Damn it! Not this again!" And as soon as Merno winds up teleporting and opening the portal back up behind Whis, he then went along to ask him, "Now where were we, Whis?" So it looks like Merno's prime focus here is in fact his brother, because he's not too concerned with Goku, he's not too concerned with Beerus, and as soon as Merno was shown fighting Whis, Merno then went along to ask him, "I feel your anger towards me beginning to overtake you, Whis. Go ahead and show me why you are one of the strongest angels of our race, or are you scared?" And the second Goku and Beerus attempt to charge back in, Goku then went along to tell Beerus, "Hey Lord Beerus, you feel that? His energy is different again. He's about to use more of his power." So Goku and Beerus are now beginning to feel that Merno is beginning to change, as right before Whis actually makes contact, once again, Merno quickly opens up a portal and disappears. As he then reappears right in front of everyone, he then went along to acknowledge them by telling them, "I admire your will to survive, but I can also feel the god along with the mortal Saiyan growing weaker. Is this what you want, Whis? Because I can't seem to make up my mind on which one of you to kill first, or maybe I should break my limits and destroy this universe altogether in one shot. I think that would be much better. As he is then shown stepping out of the portal, he then continues, "All I've ever asked for was to be heard. My cries were ignored, my questions were left unanswered, while your lives continued. I was left to die while you were allowed to live. I will never forget that. I will never let it go. But this is it. You wanted me at my best? Fine. This is where it all ends for the three of you. No more games, no more fun. Your blood spills here. I will bathe the multiverse in your blood." And that's when Merno breaks his limits in having to unleash his full power with everyone acknowledging this. Goku then went along to utter, "Whoa, he wasn't lying. I've never felt anything like this in my entire life. What a horrible power." With Whis having to cry out, "We are forbidden from using this power. Stop this." But then, over out in another dimension, we finally get to see how the original seems to be dwelling by himself, as he went along to tell the clone, "Your time with them is up, clone." And the clone is absolutely shook, because the clone Merno was just about to unleash and reveal his true power onto the surface until the original stopped him. And because of this, the clone is shook, as the original then goes on to tell him, "I have acquired all that is needed from them. You have one more task in the seventh, so return to me now. The time to purge the multiverse is nearly here. You will return to me right this moment." So the games are done, and the clone now is beginning to understand that the original is calling for him, as we only then get to see little snippets of what the original looks like. He then went along to continue, "There is one more matter I need you to look into. The others will arrive shortly. Now return to me at once. These worms will be mine to address." And with the clone Merno looking up, he then went along to utter, "Yes, of course. Now I see." And with his focus then redirected back at Beerus, Whis, and Goku, Merno then went along to tell them, "Well, it seems as though you worms have bought yourselves some time before you are erased. It's sad that our battle had to end this way, but I have other matters to attend to. But don't worry, you'll see me soon enough, except next time, you won't be so lucky, especially after I return with my original body and power. In the meantime, feel free to attack me. None of it will make a difference now that the plan is complete," with Whis having to respond, "You will not get away with what you've done as easily as you think." With Merno then asking, "And who's going to stop me? You? Please. You were barely able to keep up without struggling. You've fallen off. Lazy, just like your destroyer. And don't think about the other angels helping you either. They have their hands full as we speak." So, an ominous warning by Merno in telling his brother that his siblings aren't going to help him because they currently have their hands full as well, with Beerus having to ask, What have you done with the others?" With Goku also asking, "He attacked the other universes as well?" And as the portal beneath Merno opens, with Merno having to descend, he then went along to tell them, "Oh, you'll see. I'm not obligated to answer you, but I'll tell you this much. The others won't save you from what's about to happen. So for the time being, I hope you rest well. Because when I come back, you'll be resting in the ground for good this time. There will be no miracles. Before you kill me, I will end everything with my own two hands. I want you to remember something, Whis. When you're going for revenge, remember to always dig two graves. One for yourself, and one for the person you're going after. In this case here, I've dug many for all of you, but before I am buried, I will see to it that I put all of you in yours first. There will be no survivors, and there will be no amount of power that will help you." With Whis then having to tell him, "You won't get away with any of this. You've sealed your fate, and you will pay for everything you've done." And right before the portal consumes Merno, in a very creepy way with Merno's eyes having to stare back at his brother, he then went along to tell him, "And until then, I will be seeing you very, very soon." Merno had now made his exit in reassuring Whis, Beerus, and Goku that in fact he will be back. However, the next time he decides to show up is going to be when everyone's going to meet their end, and with Whis having to be shown staring up at the sky, he then went along to comment, "What's he up to? If his original body and power are nearly complete, then why retreat? Is there something behind what he said? Something's not right. I don't sense his presence anywhere, which means his consciousness and power are being masked somewhere. Somewhere he cannot be located, and with Goku shown plopping down on the ground and having to revert back down to his base form, in being in a very weakened state, he went along to comment, "Ah, man, what a battle. My body feels as if it's been shattered into a million pieces. He's too much." And with Beerus also shown having to be bloody and battle damaged, he went along to then comment, "I never stood a chance. Obtaining Ultra Instinct only helped me maintain the fight. He was hiding so much power from me. I couldn't stop him." And with Whis overseeing Beerus and Goku on the ground, he then went along to tell them both, "For what it's worth, I commend you both for being able to endure the punishment you did. You both held your own as much as you could against him, so don't beat yourselves up for failing to stop him. That opportunity will come as soon as we continue to improve and prepare. Now I need you both to stand back up and continue to fight this battle." And with Whis summoning his staff, he then continues, "We may not have enough time either, so we must not waste it while we have it." And with Whis shown having to heal Beerus first, he then continues, "You did more than what you could, Lord Beerus. Now stand back up. This is not the hill that we will die on today." And with Beerus fully recovering, he further proceeded to stand back up and having to look at his hands and commenting, "We attacked him all at once. And he stood his ground and fought back effortlessly. If he could do that and still hide his power, then how do we destroy him, Whis?" And with Whis shown then healing Goku, he went along to then answer, "Although he is powerful, my lord, there is nothing that cannot be destroyed outside of the Omni King himself. And now you, Goku, up you go. You are needed." And with Goku also having to stand up and looking at his hands, he then also went along to continue, "Each time we seem to fight this guy, he always pulls another trick out of his hat. To think that not even Ultra Instinct was enough to stop him kind of makes me wonder on what more we need to do, especially now if what he says is true." And with Beerus having to then walk on over towards Goku, he then went along to tell him, "And you, Goku, this will be the only time I will say this to you, so listen closely to my words. I do not owe you, nor did I ever call for your aid in this battle against the Angel, but you did your best out there, and for what it's worth, you were there for me when I was down, and for that, you have my respect and highest praise. You did what you could, and that's all that matters in the end. We're even." And with Beerus shown extending his hand, he then tells Goku, "Now stand up, Saiyan," because in fact this is true, Goku was there prior to Merno actually following through and destroying Beerus once Goku and Whis had come to his aid. And with Goku shown standing back up and grabbing onto Beerus's hand, he then went along to tell him, "Thank you, Lord Beerus. I don't think I could have survived out there against him without you." But then that's when Beerus went along to tell him, "Don't get ahead of yourself though, Saiyan. Remember, I never asked for your help, and I never will. So next time, when I tell you to stay out of my way, I mean it. Otherwise, I will erase you on the spot myself." And with Beerus shown having to throw a tantrum and quickly turning around, Goku then went along to ask him, "Hey, take it easy, Lord Beerus. If you erase me, then who will supply you with all the delicious food from Earth and contact Bulma?" But that's when Beerus turned around and telling Goku, "I still have Vegeta, you fool." "Well, that sucks," Goku says. "Speaking of, I wonder what Vegeta is up to and what his training is like with the Grand Priest." But that's when Whis caught wind of something and having to intervene by telling the two, "Speaking of training, that could be what would be ideal for you both right now. It's been quite some time, but I feel as if this would work. It could be useful. In order for us to be prepared for whatever comes, I want you both to train for a short time. Growth is growth, and you both need it in order to be ready." "Train?" Goku and Beerus utter, because they were absolutely taken back by Whis's offer, as Whis went along to then tell them, "I will grant you both 5 minutes, and once this is over, we will move on to phase 2 of the plan." And with Goku and Beerus having to then look at each other, Whis then continues, "There is no need to hold back. Do what is needed and remember what's on the line here." So Whis is further suggesting that this would be a really good and pragmatic idea for both Beerus and Goku to train in better getting accustomed to whatever comes involving Merno, because with Merno's threats having to now stick, our heroes really don't have any other choice but to prepare for what's about to come. And with both Beerus and Goku getting ready, Beerus went along to then tell Goku, "Just so you know, Goku, Ultra Instinct or not, I won't be holding back against you. Now give it all you've got, with Goku responding, as do you. I don't know why I'm a little nervous. Maybe it's because it's been a while since we fought, but I'm ready. This time, the outcome will be in my favor, and with Whis having to observe this, he went along to then utter, wonderful. Now, begin, as over out in another dimension, we get to finally see how the original Merno is beginning to talk to one of his clones, as he further went along to tell him, it amazes me to see how lightly you are taking the situation when you were ordered to bring back what is needed and kill those who stood in your way. Defy my order again, and I will tear your spirit in half. The others are currently finishing their missions with the other universes. Its information on its warriors and deities have been gathered. However, there is one more task, as the clone Merno went along to ask, so I take it the others will be returning soon then? And where do you need me to be prior to our resurrection? With the original telling the clone, head on over to planet C76F, 421G, the outer rim of Universe 7. Find Vegeta. He is there with the Grand Priest. Gather what you can, and kill him if needed. As only then the clone is shown having to smile, he then responded, ah, Vegeta. Wonderful. So, the original's final order to one of the clones is to go out and see what Vegeta is up to, gather as much power and information as he can, and if need be, kill Vegeta in the process of doing so, as only then we finally get to see how Vegeta is once again continuing his training with the Grand Priest, as Vegeta is shown laying down on the ground both battle damaged and bruised, as he went along to utter, I think I got it. I feel like I'm dying. I've never felt such pain in my entire life. And with the Grand Priest having to hover over Vegeta, he then went along to tell him, well done, Vegeta. You're growing more accustomed to this power, but our training is far from over. I will need you to stand back up and fight me using this power. And with the Grand Priest shown healing Vegeta, he then continues, I'm impressed that you were able to last this long. Any other mortal would have died from the pressure. And as Vegeta went along to sit back up, he then asks, so you're saying this still may not be enough? How many levels of power are there if there will always be one above it? No matter the outcome, I will try again, with the Grand Priest telling Vegeta, an angel's power has no bounds, but it does stop where mine begins, as well as the great Omni King. You've proven to have grown, but this power must be tested and mastered before achieving new levels of strength. Merno had taken an interest in you more so than Goku due to your ability to show no mercy. Now you will continue as if your life depends on it. So, although Vegeta had seemingly achieved a new level of power according to the Grand Priest, there are so many levels of power that are far beyond what Vegeta had achieved right now, but in order for Vegeta to gradually go on ahead and achieve new levels of power, what he must do is fully be able to test and master the current power he has going on, and with the Grand Priest then telling him, now we will continue as we did, Vegeta went along to then look at his hands and commenting, I can't believe how powerful this guy has made me in such a short period of time. It's crazy to think that Merno could still be even stronger than me, but I have to keep trying and pushing myself beyond my limits. I'm ready. As he then continues, just so we're clear, I will be fighting you with the intent to kill you. I hope you're ready. This time, I'm going to break through and put you down, and you will not be making a fool out of me again. From there, we will take this battle to Merno and finish this once and for all. Now bring it on. I'm ready, as the Grand Priest responds, as you wish, Vegeta. But just know, I won't be taking it as easy on you this time around. Use your new power and learn about it as you engage. The ball is in your court. Now make your move. But then, out of nowhere, a voice then went along to tell the Grand Priest as Merno winded up showing up behind him, as Merno claps very menacingly as he went along to tell the Grand Priest, what a fantastic speech, Father. Condescending as usual. And here, I assumed you were doing something productive. You seem a little different, Vegeta. I wonder why. Oh well, it doesn't matter because you both will be dead regardless, as Vegeta went along to respond, the only dead man speaking is the one standing halfway through that portal, you scum. I know why you're here, and it doesn't matter because the end result will not be as you expect, with Merno having to ask, confident now, are we? And what makes you so sure with Vegeta having to approach Merno by telling him, "Because I've acquired a new level of power, far beyond anything you've seen from me before. And now that I have this, it's only a matter of time before you are crushed." With Merno asking, "A new power? What new power? You're bluffing." And that's when Vegeta went along to tell him, "So then call my bluff. I'm about to show you an ancient power that will make you regret ever coming back into existence. Now let's just see what you can do." So Vegeta is calm, cool, collected, he's confident, and he's ready to showcase the fruits of his training against Merno, but even then Merno doesn't seem to take Vegeta serious at all until Vegeta begins to power up. And with Merno having to acknowledge this, he went along to then tell him, "You speak of acquiring an ancient power as if you're so sure of defeating me. Let me remind you of something, Vegeta. You could never destroy me. Ever. I've proved this to you many times before when I made an example out of you. Nothing's changed," with Vegeta responding, "I'll let you assume whatever it is that gives you confidence against me, but unlike before, this time, things are going to be a little different. You might be more powerful than me because you have angel blood flowing through your veins, but that doesn't mean that you can't be dropped. I did it before, and I'm going to do it again. Suppress yourself all you'd like, but let me show you what I mean." And that's when Vegeta transforms directly into Super Saiyan Blue Evolution, and with Merno seeing this, he went along to ask, "Is this the power? You talk about acquiring a new power, and this is what you resort into using again? Oh, you'll kill me, alright. Kill me with laughter is what you'll do. What a joke," because Merno thinks that this is all fun and games, that Vegeta had not acquired anything beyond Super Saiyan Blue Evolution, and with Vegeta shown smirking, he went along to then tell him, "We'll see who's laughing soon." So there's confidence coming from Vegeta, there's confidence coming from Merno, and they're both so sure of themselves that this fight is going to go in their favor, but Merno took action in not wanting to waste any more time, in directly having to dash at Vegeta by telling him, "Indeed we will. But in the meantime, show me this super secret power of yours that is boosting your ego." And as Merno attempted to punch Vegeta, Vegeta so casually moved out of the way and telling him, "Things aren't going to be the same, Merno." And this grabbed Merno's attention as he went along to ask, "He saw that? Lucky." As he then proceeded to try to kick Vegeta in the face, once again, Vegeta moved out of the way as Merno went along to tell him, "I'm only using you as a warm-up, Saiyan. Don't get ahead of yourself." As he then attempted to double axe handle Vegeta from above, Vegeta went along to block and asking, "Still think this is going to be a warm-up?" And with Merno looking down visibly annoyed, he then responded, "So you've increased your fighting senses and dodging ability, so what? Running away isn't going to do anything for you." With Vegeta looking up and having to smile and responding, "And who said I was running away?" And that's when Vegeta went along ahead to punch Merno so hard in the chest that it caused Merno to go flying up back towards the Grand Priest, ironically enough. But right before Merno actually went along ahead to crash right into his father, what he did was he braced himself before having to make impact, and as he did so, he went along to ask, "What was that just now?" "Alright, now you have my attention, mortal. The more you push back, the deeper the grave is going to be." Another lucky hit, and as soon as Merno winds up charging right back at Vegeta, he then went along to tell him, "Maybe holding back all of my power wasn't such a great idea. So allow me to kick it up a level or two then. Now let's see what you can do." As he then proceeded to punch Vegeta in the face, it's as clear as day that Merno was heavily underestimating Vegeta and his abilities, and now, being the fact that Vegeta kind of embarrassed him, even if it was for a moment, Merno is not looking to have this happen again. And as he goes on to attack Vegeta, he further went along ahead to add more insult to injury by asking, "Where is it? Where is this special power of yours that you kept talking about? I don't see it at all. All I see is a washed up mortal whose only greatest weapon is his pride." And as soon as Merno knocks Vegeta down, he then continues, "You could have been made into the greatest to ever stand by my side, but instead, you decided to turn against me, to turn against obtaining true power, to turn against becoming a ruler, only to be a peasant." And with the Grand Priest watching this, he further went along to say to himself, This is what we've prepared for. Merno is clearly holding back, but even while suppressed, his power still dwarfs Vegeta's current form. He is doing exactly what I wanted Vegeta to do. Feel Merno out first before making his next move. You brought this on yourself, Merno. If, and only if, the mortals cannot destroy him, then this will force my hand. I am forbidden by the Omni Kings to engage, but if my actions are needed, then I will do what I must. And with Merno shown continuously attacking Vegeta, punching Vegeta, kicking Vegeta, he kept on antagonizing him by asking, "Not winning as easily as you thought, Vegeta? I knew you were bluffing." And with Merno knocking Vegeta down, Vegeta went along to say to himself, "I knew he'd do this." He's simply masking his power to match mine while holding his full power back from us. It was just as the Grand Priest had said. Now I see. So, the Grand Priest had further prepped Vegeta just in case this would actually happen, and being the fact that indeed this is currently happening to Vegeta, it wasn't as if this wasn't going to be expected from Merno because this was ingrained within the plan, and as soon as Vegeta looks up, he notices how Merno is just about to come crashing on down as he went along to tell Vegeta, "Don't sleep yet, Saiyan. You'll be napping when I say you'll be napping, and until then, I am going to enjoy kicking your brains out." And that's exactly what Merno does, because he winds up stomping down on Vegeta over and over and over again as he tells him, "Try and fight back, Saiyan! Fight back! Show me what you can do!" And right after he winds up kicking Vegeta multiple times, what he ends up doing is he jumps up and down, stomping down on Vegeta as much as he could by telling him, "You're a liar, a pawn in this game of mine. You are one of the prime examples of what it means to be a disgrace. And when this is all over, you will only be but an afterthought. I should learn to never accept anything promising from the Prince of All Disappointment. What a waste of my time. So before I end you, any last words?" And with Vegeta looking up and smiling, he then tells Merno, "You're doomed." And this gets Merno's attention because he went along to ask, "I'm what? What could possibly be so funny, you weakling? You dare treat me as if I'm a joke? How dare you?" And that's when Merno bounced back and having to then tell Vegeta, "We'll see who's doomed then. To the afterlife with you, worm." As Merno directly winded up firing a blast directly at Vegeta, who, mind you, who is still lying down within the crater, and with a massive explosion having to be seen, Merno assumes this is it as he went along to smile and asking, "What was it now? I was doomed? But I don't hear you talking anymore, mortal. What a waste." There was nothing to gather on him. It was the same old power and the same old failed promises. Typical. Now then, Dad, I think you and I have some unfinished business to attend to. You should be ashamed to have trained such a pathetic creature. Did you really think he was going to match me? I think it's time you and I..." But then, Merno begins to detect something coming from the crater as he asks, "What was that?" And through the smoke, Vegeta then went along to tell Merno, "I honestly was having doubts on being able to stop you with my own power at first. That is, until the Grand Priest had took me in and showed me a few things that I had overlooked. Although I may not be strong enough to beat you at this current level, it was thanks to him that I was able to discover a greater form beyond this. A transformation worthy of the gods." And with Vegeta having to be shown stepping through and smiling, he then continues, "You look a little surprised. Is it because you assumed I'd be ragdolled by you like before? What's even more interesting is that I still haven't fully completed my training with the Grand Priest before you arrived. But I think with what I've learned from him, it should be enough to get the job done." As Merno went along to ask, "And what could you possibly have achieved? You don't have Ultra Instinct, which is the apex of power to the gods, so what makes you so sure of yourself? Did you forget that I am leveling my strength to match yours? I could have killed you a long time ago, but since you're beginning to really anger me, either put up or be destroyed." With Vegeta responding, "I know what you're doing. I know you could have killed me, but that was before. Think you can do it now? What you're about to see is the apex power of my people, merged together with the power of the gods. With Merno asking, what apex power? With Vegeta telling him, Primal Super Saiyan Blue. And it was at that moment where Vegeta began to power up in such a way that this garnered Merno's attention as Merno went along to ask, what? What is this power? He's beginning to change, and change he is because Vegeta's pupils are gone, his muscles are increasing in size, so Vegeta is shown clearly having to evolve at this point by showing Merno that in fact he did discover a power far beyond Super Saiyan Blue evolution, as meanwhile back with Beerus and Goku as they were beginning to spar and taking a momentary break, Goku went along to ask, hey wait, Lord Beerus, do you sense that? This power... it feels like Vegeta, with Beerus responding, Whis, tell me. Has Merno found his way to Vegeta that's drawing this power out? With Whis responding, this is indeed Vegeta's power, but it would seem as though he's evolved. His power has risen beyond anything he's achieved on his own before, so even as far away as on Beerus's planet, Goku, Vegeta, Whis, everyone is beginning to detect and feel the depth and magnitude of Vegeta's new power, and because of this, Goku gets very excited as he went along to then comment, wow, his power is outstanding! I've never felt power like this before! Is this a new level of power? I don't know what kind of training he's done, but this is amazing to witness! Maybe when this is all over, I could finally have at it with him and see how strong he truly is, but then, Beerus interjects by having to punch Goku in the face by telling him, pay attention, you idiot! How could you be daydreaming during a time like this? Quit wasting time and use your Ultra Instinct power right now! You're slowing the process down! Do as you're told and continue this fight, with Goku having to respond, hey, take it easy, Lord Beerus! Alright, alright! No need to get all angry, and as soon as Goku winds up calming down, Beerus responds, hurry up, Saiyan, and that's when Goku went along ahead to calm himself down in reactivating the powers of Mastered Ultra Instinct by commenting, I have to focus. When it's all said and done, I will make you pay for what you've done, Merno. Even if you're stronger than me, I will find a way to destroy you. For my friends, for my family, for the universe. It's the only way. So being the fact that Beerus had called Goku into taking this fight more serious, and with Beerus wanting Goku to show him the fruits of his power, Goku wastes little time in having to reignite the powers of Mastered Ultra Instinct, and with Beerus having to look on, he then went along to tell Goku, now then, Saiyan, show me what your Ultra Instinct power can do. I've noticed your body still isn't fully adjusted to its incredible power. You better not burn yourself out during this fight. Once we take care of Merno, I just want to let you know that you're next on the list, Goku. Now come on, so Beerus seems excited on being able to fight Goku, even if it is for a brief time in order for them to train and better prepare themselves against Merno. Meanwhile, back on a remote planet, we get to see how Merno is then shielding himself from the amount of pressure that Vegeta is creating, and with Merno anticipating Vegeta's next transformation, he then went along to ask, what kind of power is this? Where is he getting all of this energy from? Troublesome little worm. And as Vegeta is shown transforming, his hair is getting longer, his muscle mass is beginning to increase in size, and with Merno continuously staring on, he then continues, no amount of power will save you from what's coming. And you can see how this planet is beginning to shake based on the overwhelming amount of pressure that Vegeta is creating. With Vegeta's aura having to extend far enough into outer space, we finally get to then bear witness to Vegeta's ultimate transformation. With Merno staring on, he then asks, what is this? He looks different than he was before. His energy is unusually massive. He's merged powers with something, didn't he? Interesting. And with Vegeta having to be shown finally revealing Primal Super Saiyan Blue, he then went along to tell Merno, excuse the time it took to reveal this power. I didn't really have too much time to practice this one. Now allow me to introduce you to the ancient power of my Saiyan people, the primal power of the legendary Great Ape, condensed and merged together with the powers of Super Saiyan Blue. If you believe the outcome of our battle is going to be the same as it was before, then you are in for a very rude awakening, fallen angel. Suppress yourself to match my power and you will die as an end result. choose your next move wisely. And with Merno having to acknowledge this, he then asks, and what makes you so sure that things will be different? With Vegeta responding, because now I have the power to end your life. And Merno's treating this like an absolute joke as he went along to respond, to end my life? You'll probably kill me with laughter than you ever would with power alone. Your head seems more inflated than it was before, so I guess I'll take you up on that offer and prove to you once again on why you are and will forever be helpless to destroy me in battle, Vegeta. And with Merno then dashing straight towards Vegeta, he then went along to tell him, let me show you exactly what I mean, mortal. And the second Merno throws a punch, what Vegeta does is he grabs onto Merno's fist as he went along to utter what the, with Vegeta telling Merno, your greatest mistake was giving me time to grow as a warrior. But I wouldn't expect for you to know anything about that. You know nothing about growth or honor. And with Merno held in place, he followed up by having to clinch his left arm and having to tell Vegeta, your mouth of yours has been more taxing on me than your puny power, mortal. Let me correct that for you. But then, as soon as Merno winds up attempting to punch Vegeta in the face, Vegeta winds up grabbing onto both hands as he then tells him, it's as I had told you. This time, things will be much different than they were before. With Merno then telling Vegeta, you're getting carried away as you did before, Saiyan. Am I? Vegeta utters. Let me show you why. And that's when Vegeta proceeded to kick Merno out in the distance by telling him, on my honor, I will never allow you to disrespect my race or myself ever again. The Saiyans of your former universe could never know of such power as the one I have achieved. And neither can you, as Merno's body is sent crashing all throughout the landscape. All of a sudden, before Merno's body could be sent out flying any further, Vegeta winds up teleporting behind him as Merno's body comes crashing into him, with Vegeta telling Merno, your presence will be eliminated from my universe, Merno. But that's when Merno went along to counter by telling Vegeta, not if I smash your head in, Saiyan worm. Keep dreaming. And that's when Merno attempted to backhand Vegeta's head off, but what Vegeta winds up doing is ducking right under and delivering a bone-rattling shot to Merno's stomach as Vegeta tells Merno, smash my head in, you say? That doesn't sound like a bad idea. For you, that is. Shall we try? And that's when Vegeta winds up grabbing Merno by the face by telling him, let's start by using yours. So, clearly enough, Vegeta is demonstrating feats that are far beyond Merno, because keep in mind, Merno is leveling himself out to match Vegeta in this case, but so as long as he does this, Vegeta is going to gain the upper hand, unless Merno actually decides to turn it up and show Vegeta the depths of his power. But then, as soon as Vegeta winds up grabbing Merno by the face, he then went along to further drag him down by telling him, I am going to show you what it means to feel the power of a true Saiyan warrior. And that's when Vegeta went along to smash Merno's face down on the ground, but he didn't just simply slam Merno's face down on the ground, but instead, he winded up dragging Merno's body through the entire planet and having to pop out through the other side, which goes as far as to show Vegeta's ruthless tenacity in having to take this battle as serious as he could. And the level of punishment that he's dishing out to Merno now is unlike anything he's done to him before, and with Vegeta popping out through the other side, he then went along to tell Merno, you're nothing but a reject. A washed away relic from a long forgotten time. And yet you speak as if you are the mightiest in all of creation, when that couldn't be further from the truth, coward. And that's when Vegeta winded up kicking Merno so hard that Merno went crashing through the landscape, as Vegeta went along to then comment, you claim you want to rebuild creation by ridding it of the Omni King and all other gods, but you lack the focus to do so. And it's because you can't. Not like this. And being that I will be the last thing you ever see, you will never fulfill that goal. But then the Grand Priest shows up as he garners Vegeta's attention by telling him, Vegeta, remember what I had told you about this power. Remember what I had told you about Merno. The sands within the hourglass must not be wasted. And with Vegeta having to look down on his hands, he then went along to say to himself, I'm not sure how long I have in holding this form, but I never would have imagined to have power like this before. It's almost too overwhelming to fully control. But as Vegeta begins to acknowledge and reassess his power, out of nowhere, a blast comes hurtling towards Vegeta as Vegeta went along to comment, "Come at me as you'd like, Angel, but your hour has finally arrived." With Vegeta then deflecting his attack, he then continues, "Masking your power and switching it on and off will be your downfall." But once again, Merno is not having it as he winds up opening a portal behind Vegeta in his attempts of striking him. With Merno attempting to do so and with Vegeta grabbing onto his punch, Merno then went along to ask him, "And who are you to be talking down onto me, Saiyan? You're just a pathetic mortal with a short lifespan in this universe while I live on forever. My blood cannot be compared to yours. You are imperfect creatures who will no longer exist in my utopia." But that's when Vegeta went along to ask, "Is that so, Merno?" Well then, as he proceeded to pull him right through the portal, he then continues, "Stop hiding your true power and show me." And with Merno shown plopping down onto the ground, Vegeta went along to then look down and telling him, "Face it, Angel, it's over. It doesn't matter what you do, you will never survive what I am now. Now either fight me using your full power and die with a shred of honor to your name, or be erased on your knees like the coward that you are. Now what's it going to be? I know you're hiding something, so if there was ever a time to reveal it, this is it. Now make your move or be destroyed." And with Merno shown having to slowly rise up from his knees, he then tells Vegeta, "Impressive, Vegeta. I knew you'd be the one to shatter my expectations about you, but you're beginning to sound a lot like my father. Don't you worry. I will make my move on you very soon. So I'd say you've gotten the better of me, but now it's time for round two. But this time, I will be giving you exactly what you've been asking from me." With Merno showing clear signs of irritation after having to be bested by Vegeta in battle by now having to turn to his father in addressing him, Merno further went along to tell the Grand Priest, "This is all your fault. None of this would ever have been an issue if you had just simply laid down and died. And yet you decided to train the mortal over doing what was right for your own son and former guardian of the 13th universe." And with the Grand Priest looking down, he then went along to respond to him, "There is nothing you can say to me that will reverse the outcome of your fate. You will soon be dealt with, and this time, you will not be coming back into existence. That I can surely promise you," with Merno having to point up and responding, "And I promise you that I will tear your soul apart once my original body and battle power is recovered and restored. For what you've done to me and for the things you've allowed, I will never forgive you. I will end you forever." And that's when Merno proceeded to fire a blast directly at the Grand Priest, but before Merno's attack can actually make contact with the Grand Priest, what Vegeta winds up doing is teleporting right in front of the attack by telling Merno, "Not while I'm around, you won't." And that's when Vegeta went along to deflect the attack by telling Merno, "Your fight is with me. The Grand Priest is none of your concern as long as I'm here." But Merno's not having it because what he winds up doing is opening up a portal and then telling Vegeta, "Well then, how about we get rid of you then since you're really beginning to get under my skin, Saiyan?" And as Merno proceeds to open up a small portal in front of Vegeta by showing his face, he then asks him, "What do you say we kick it up a notch or two then?" And that's when Merno proceeds to attack Vegeta from all corners. There are multiple portals shown opening all around Vegeta as Merno continuously attacks him by telling him, "Oh come on, Saiyan, you were so full of yourself just a minute ago. Am I turning up the fire a bit too much for you? Are you starting to feel the heat?" But with Vegeta beginning to guard himself, he then went along to comment, "Damn it, he's jumped in power tremendously. I can't slip up and let him get ground on me." But that's when Merno winds up teleporting right out of his portal and then having to pop up behind Vegeta and asking him, "Did you really think you were in control of this battle, princess? Like I said, you got lucky." And that's when Merno winds up kicking Vegeta below by then telling him, "Now down to the ground where you belong, dog." But with Vegeta then having to be shown landing back on his feet, he then went along to tell Merno, "We'll see which one of us will be lying on the ground, coward. Don't assume that I haven't prepared for this." And with Vegeta leaping right back up, he then tells him, "Now allow me to pay you back for that." And that's when Vegeta winds up connecting a very powerful right hook to Merno Merno's stomach as Vegeta went along to ask him, "Do you feel that? Wasn't expecting for me to bounce back so quickly after knocking me down, did you? It's over. This battle was long over the minute you decided to come to this planet, Angel." And with Merno absolutely taken back by this and having to spit out blood, he then went along to say to himself, "This can't be happening." As he then asks Vegeta, "How did you get powerful this quickly? You are but a mere mortal, gum beneath my shoes. What did that traitor father of mine teach you?" But that's when Vegeta winds up grabbing Merno by the hair and telling him, "He's taught me that despite my level of power, there will always be a higher level above it. And although I'm far from reaching an angel's power, I can as hell contest it. My body had also been hardened by fighting your father until I was nearing death. And because of this, I am able to handle more than before." So it was due to the Grand Priest's training that Vegeta's body is now able to sustain much more damage than how it was before. And even though Vegeta also confirms that yes, indeed, he is far from reaching an angel's power, but it was because of the Grand Priest's training that allowed Vegeta's body to actually get used to all this punishment. And that's when Vegeta is shown just continuously slapping Merno across the face over and over and over again, as Vegeta then tells him, "You dare disrespect me? Do you honestly think I'd ever submit to you to be your little pawn? You disrespect my name by putting my family in danger, nearly harming my children and destroying my planet. How does it feel? How does it feel to be helpless?" And with Vegeta shown smacking Merno, Merno then went along to tell Vegeta, "I'm going to slaughter you, Vegeta, and your family, and I'll make you watch every second of it as you watch them burn." But Vegeta doesn't stop there, because he continuously smacks Merno by then telling him, "As if I would ever let you. To get to them, you will have to get by me, which you never will, I promise you that. I will continue to slap you around until I knock that head clean off your body. Now let's finish this once and for all." But then, that's when Merno went along to stick his hand right in front of Vegeta's face and telling him, "I agree, mortal. Let's." And that's when Merno winds up firing a massive blast directly in Vegeta's face, in catching Vegeta off guard, because the last thing Vegeta was expecting was for Merno to actually go on ahead and blast him from point blank range. And with Vegeta shown falling down on the ground, Merno winds up rematerializing right in front of Vegeta by having to ask him, "Oh, what happened, Mr. Tough Warrior? Didn't you say something about finally putting me down? Ironic, isn't it, how you're the one who's laying down like the worm you are. You were right about one thing. You could never match an angel's power. However," and that's when Merno went along to kick Vegeta further out in the distance by telling him, "You did say your body is more hardened for battle. Then let's just see how much it can take." And with Vegeta shown crashing into the distance and having to smack right into a mountain, Merno quickly follows him by then having to tell Vegeta, "Don't fall asleep on me yet, Saiyan. I have so much to pay you back for." And with Merno shown having to punch Vegeta in the face over and over and over again, he then continues, "I'm debating on whether or not I should keep you alive long enough to watch your family die, or smash your face in now and get it over with for good. Now then, puny god, any last words before you die? So much for the quote mighty Saiyan warrior. Long live the prince of no one mortal." What the? But that's when Merno looks down and noticing how Vegeta has his hands placed on his chest, with Vegeta telling Merno, "You shouldn't waste time, Angel. Long live the prince indeed." Gallic Cannon! And that's when Vegeta fires this massive attack that overtakes Merno, and with Merno shown screaming out in the distance, Vegeta in fact has proven that his body is hardened enough to go up against Merno. Despite all of the punishment received by Merno, we get to see how Merno is being pushed back by this blast and having to cry out, "I will not be destroyed by you!" So Merno is trying his best to push this blast back, but as soon as Vegeta notices this, he then went along to tell him, "We'll see about that, Angel. Now let's see if you can survive this one. Now close!" And the second Vegeta clenches his fists, the blast erupts, creating a massive explosion out in the distance, and you can see this from space because this blast created such an impact on the planet itself that we get to see from space how this massive crater seems to engulf one third of the planet itself, as Whis himself back on Beerus' planet is able to detect this as he went along to comment, "What incredible energy. Vegeta seems to be going all out against my brother, but I sense a disturbance looming. Vegeta appears to be besting Merno, but I'm afraid his power is unstable. Meanwhile, over out on the other side, Mastered Ultra Instinct Goku and Beerus continue to train, with Goku having to ask Beerus, "I take it you want to try and get Ultra Instinct 2 again, is that right, Lord Beerus?" With Beerus responding, "How about you quit holding back and stop talking and fight, Saiyan?" So it's as clear as day that these two are trying to train and being able to further discover their flaws in getting better during the course of this battle, as of course this was originally set up by Whis. With the two having to battle, Goku then went along to tell Beerus, "If it means getting stronger to finally put an end to Merno, then I won't hold back. And if you're also planning on tapping back into Ultra Instinct against him, then allow me to push you there." With Beerus having to respond, "The only thing you're pushing is your luck in this battle, Saiyan. Focus on the task at hand." With Whis having to observe this, he also went along to comment, "I'm amazed at how focused they are in wanting to get stronger to stop Merno, but I'm afraid if we don't take care of this problem soon, then our chances of destroying him will be nearly none." And as we then go back to Vegeta, who was shown patiently waiting to find out if Merno is dead or not, he then went along to comment, "That was one of my strongest attacks. There's no way he could walk away easily from that level of attack. I sense something. If I don't hurry up, this power will burn right through and I'll be right back to square one. I can't risk it." And through the smoke, we get to then see how Merno erupts in a massive rage-like state and having to cry out, "Vegeta!" As he then reignites the power of Ultra Instinct, he then went along to tell Vegeta, "Now you've done it. I commend you in reaching this level of strength and being able to draw out more from me, but this is where you die. Remember when I said I was leveling my power with yours? Well, I got what I wanted out of you without you even knowing what hit you. But then again, I wouldn't expect you to even know. You'll see soon enough. You'll be lucky to survive our next encounter. Now let's see how good you are when I'm using more of my power." With Merno now having to reignite the powers of Ultra Instinct following his initial battle against Primal Vegeta, Merno then went along to shout at Vegeta by asking, "Do you think this power of yours changes anything, Vegeta? Did you forget who you are when compared to me? You are nothing but a pawn. This level of yours will soon expire, just like your life when I'm finished with you." With Vegeta responding, "Well then, if you're so sure about ending my life, then why don't you come and try to take it from me? We've destroyed your clones before, and we'll surely do it again." And that's when Merno went along ahead to address his father by then telling him, "This is all your fault, as it always was since taking everything away from me when you did. I swear, father, on my honor, I will tear you to pieces when this is all over. I will take from you just as you have taken from me." As he then went along to point at him, he then continues, "I know you're hiding your true power. With everything on the line, why don't you come and try to stop me? I'll tell you why. It's because you still answer to him." With the Grand Priest responding, "And what makes you so sure of yourself? You will never see the day where you will touch the great Omni King, so as long as I'm around, and as long as the other angels and mortals like Vegeta are around, you will continue to lose until each of your clones, including your original body, are completely destroyed." "Or so you think," says Merno, as he then proceeded to charge directly at the Grand Priest by then telling him, "I cannot wait to see the look on your face when I am finally fully restored to my former glory. Then, and only then, I will eat you alive for what you've done to me. There will be no mercy," as the Grand Priest tells him, "In case you've forgotten, Merno, I am not your primary enemy at the moment." And that's when Primal Vegeta winds up swooping in from behind and kicking Merno in the neck by asking, "What did I tell you about never taking your eyes off me?" And that's when Merno braces himself in having to respond, "You dirty little creature. Even though you've grown through new levels of power, I am going to burn you out and finish what I should have been when I laid my eyes on you." As he then went along to reignite the powers of Ultra Instinct, he then comments, "Now allow me to put this primal power of yours to shame and make an example out of you once again, mortal." And with Vegeta charging directly in, he then went along to say to himself, "I've got to hurry up and put an end to this before this power runs out. I'm not sure how much longer I have, but now that he's channeled Ultra Instinct onto the surface, this is going to be tougher than before. And that's exactly what ends up happening, because every single time Vegeta attempts to strike Merno, every single time Vegeta attempts to kick Merno, Merno effortlessly dodges him as he went along to ask, "You still haven't figured it out yet, have you, Vegeta? You can never win on your own. But you've been providing me with exactly what I needed out of you." As he further proceeded to dodge Vegeta and then grabbing him by the face, Merno then continues, "But I don't expect for someone as pathetic as you to understand, Vegeta. I will smash this primal power of yours into pieces." With Vegeta having to say to himself, "Damn it, I have to act now," because Vegeta is now beginning to understand and be more wary of the situation and the fact that Merno now is getting stronger, his Ultra Instinct is beginning to outweigh Vegeta's primal power, and with Vegeta having to then swipe away Merno's hand, he then tells him, "I will not let you make a fool of me again." And once again, Vegeta desperately tries to attack Merno, but Merno once again is simply dodging everything, with Merno having to tell Vegeta, "But you've always been a fool, Vegeta. You could have been a god to a new world, a new universe, one where only the strong thrive and the weak perish. But instead, you decided to choose a life of mediocrity." But then, right before he was actually able to connect the punch to Vegeta, Vegeta ends up elbowing Merno by telling him, "I picked freedom over slavery," with Merno responding, "You picked wrong, Saiyan," as he then uses his hand to bring Vegeta down. By using one of the gravitational techniques he has to his advantage, he then went along to tell Vegeta as he was on the ground, "I think it's time we put this bad dog to sleep, eh, Vegeta? I want to hear you beg for your life before I tear your head off your shoulders." Because now this is getting intense, and Merno wants to reassure Vegeta that before he ends his life, he wants to torture him along the way, and with Vegeta shown having to struggle back up, he then responds, "I will never force myself into submitting to you. I have to do this for my Bulma, Trunks, and my Bulma. I won't let them down." As Merno responds, "You're resisting? Do you think your family matters, Vegeta? They do not. The only true thing that matters is the destruction of your entire species in the seventh." And with Vegeta looking up smiling, he then asks, "Is it me? Or did I notice you tend to turn your Ultra Instinct on and off to preserve yourself? Am I right?" "It doesn't matter," says Merno. "You'll be dead either way." But then, Vegeta quickly counters by realizing this opportunity by taking it to kick Merno in the face by telling him, "Think again, Angel. It's best if you keep that power on at all times if you hope to kill me now." With Merno then bracing his body and saying to himself, "That rat baited me. But he's doing exactly what I want him to do. Let's see how much more he can put out before he burns it all away." So, although Merno is on the receiving end of a beatdown, he is using this opportunity to take everything he can from Vegeta as he then went along to stand back up. Merno then asks, "Is that all or is there more? Because it'll be a cold day in hell if you think that'll be enough to destroy me. You foolish, rebellious creature. You have no idea what's coming. Perhaps when this is all done, I will create a new Saiyan race who will thrive in an ever-expanding utopia, one free of limitations and boundaries. And maybe then after, I'll slaughter them all in the name of remembering you for your defiance." As Vegeta responds, "And to do that, first you'll have to make it through me. And if somehow you ever did, then I know that idiot Kakarot would have already found a way to destroy your clones for good, which leaves your original body last for the gods to rip apart. So no, there is no outcome in this situation where you walk away from this with your life. Now, are you going to make your next move, or are you going to continue to waste our time here? Because it sounds like you have nothing left to offer, which means you're finished." And Merno gets very angry, because then he went along to respond, "I'll show you who's finished." As he then sticks his hand out, he continues, "You've had this coming from the very beginning." And that's when Merno winds up firing a gigantic blast directly at Vegeta. However, there's a twist, because originally, one would assume that Merno is in fact targeting Vegeta, but instead, what he's meant by "you've had this coming since the very beginning" wasn't in direct reference to Vegeta, but instead, that was in direct direct reference to the Grand Priest, because as soon as the blast is then redirected, Vegeta comments, "What the? It's changing directions," with Merno having to shout, "Now disappear!" And with the blast having to be shown getting closer and closer and closer, finally up in the sky, the blast makes contact with the Grand Priest. And with Merno smiling, he utters, "And that settles that. Dirty traitor," with Vegeta responding, "He actually got him. No. Is he?" Because now Vegeta is beginning to worry on if the Grand Priest was injured or if anything actually happened that further hindered on the Grand Priest being involved in this situation, but through the dust and through the smoke we get to see how the Grand Priest is still indeed alive as he tells Merno, "As if your fate has not already been decided, this act will not go unpaid. Where your power ends is where mine begins. Never forget your place in all of this. You have now made the ultimate mistake," with Merno pointing up. He then responds, "And your greatest mistake was turning your back on me when I needed you the most to stand up for me. Your power begins where mine ends? Maybe for now, but it's only a matter of time before the tables are turned. Just you wait." But Vegeta then observes an opening as he went along to say to himself, "There's my opening. Now's my chance. If this fails, then I will have nothing left to continue with." He seems to be distracted. His emotions are beginning to get the better of him. It's now or never. Let's see if this works. As he then further goes on to grab onto his arm, the Grand Priest then tells Merno, "Remember these words, fallen angel. You will be eradicated from the face of existence." With Merno becoming very impatient and very furious with the Grand Priest, he further went along to ask him, "Are you going to engage with me, or will you continue to watch like the coward you are? Or is it because you're afraid? Whatever it is, it won't change the outcome of what I'm going to do to you. Now, what's it going to be? I provoked you, right? Don't you have the need to respond?" With the Grand Priest responding, "And here I expected you to know that I am still not your primary concern. My hand will be used against you in due time. Until then, you have other problems to deal with." And that's when Merno begins to then reignite the powers of Ultra Instinct by becoming even more furious at the Grand Priest by shouting, "Then if that's the case, if you won't come to me, then I'm going to come to you." But then, the Grand Priest so casually swipes his hand down and having to tell Merno, "You will do no such thing. And as a response to your attack on me, you will remain right where you are." And that's exactly what ends up happening, because Merno all of a sudden loses Ultra Instinct and can't move, in responding, "What is this? My body? I'm frozen in place. You dare bind me? You're that scared of me that you restrict my movements? You coward. You spineless coward!" As he then shouts, "I cannot be destroyed. I cannot be limited. I will be freed, and I will get my hands on you. And when I do, I will rip you away from the throne." In displaying such anger and such rage towards his father, but then, this was the opportunity, this was the opening that Vegeta had been looking for this entire time, as out of nowhere, Vegeta winds up impaling Merno from behind as he went along to shout, "Royal Sword!" in having to condense all of his energy in that of an actual sword, and as Vegeta impales Merno from behind, he then went along to lean on in and telling Merno, "I told you from the very beginning, angel, to never underestimate my ability to find a way to destroy you. Does it hurt? That's for endangering my family and threatening death to me and my race of warriors." And with Merno bleeding out and having to be shown bleeding through his chest, bleeding through his mouth, he then utters, "How dare you, Vegeta? You took advantage with the assistance of my father to help you. You coward!" With Vegeta responding, "That's right, and I told you before that I will never be your pawn in this game of yours. I am the mightiest Saiyan warrior to ever live, not a slave to a fallen angel. This is where your game ends, for good." And that's when the Grand Priest utters, "This fight is over, child." And with Merno slowly leaning back, he then addresses Vegeta by telling him, "You would have been a god among mortals, the ruler of an entire universe. You refuse to be a pawn, but yet you're a pawn of the gods and Zeno here." With Vegeta responding, "The difference is, I am free to do as I wish and not be a slave. But sinisterly enough, Merno went along to have a bloody smile on his face by responding, "So this is how it is then, huh? You're all doomed. Do you honestly think this is done? This is only the beginning. I've gotten what I needed out of you. Your graves have already been made," with Vegeta having to tell Merno, "Don't get ahead of yourself, Angel. No matter how many clones you send after us, we'll find a way to destroy them too." "You fool, Vegeta," Merno utters, as he then went along to address his father by pointing up and commenting, "The clones are the last thing you need to worry about here. As long as my original body remains, I will always find a way to come back. Did you think my mission was only to destroy you? It wasn't. If I had killed you, then it only would have been a checkmark on the list, but I've been siphoning all of your power each time I fought you," with the Grand Priest asking, "Siphoning power?" as Merno powers up and responding, "Which was why I fought you all the way I did instead of killing you like I could have. Hence why each time I didn't have a use for you and had killed you, Whis or my father had turned back time. But it's over." So Merno insinuates that this entire time he'd been siphoning and taking the power that he needed to bring back to the original, all the while, each time he managed to actually kill Broly, Gogeta, and several other people including Goku in the past, either Whis or the Grand Priest had gotten in his way to further reverse time in bringing them all back to where they were. And with Merno shown having to clinch onto his wound, he then went along to address Vegeta by telling him, "I hold the keys to the gates of destiny, not you. You think I wasn't aware that this power of yours was not fully completed? I was able to read your vitals. I knew you'd gas on me. The royal sword, was it? I'll keep that in mind." With Vegeta having to be shown struggling to stand back up, he then utters, "Damn it! He knew! He knew the entire time! You'll bleed out in no time. You are in no position to take another one of those blows, and you know it. Despite this power fading, all I need is one more shot and you're finished." But that's when Merno went along to point at his skull and responding, "But this is where once again I outclass you. Do you think I'm honestly going to allow you to do what you just did to me again? Think again, rat. You are already too late." And with Vegeta not looking to take any more chances in dashing right in, he then went along to shout, "Not until I smash you into pieces, it's not." But then Merno creates a portal behind him and having to respond, "Consider this a parting gift, Vegeta. You may have gotten the better of me now. However, I will see you again. And when I do, I am going to make you regret the day you were ever created." And right before Vegeta is just about to hit him, Merno then vanishes as Vegeta went along to comment, "Damn you, Merno! Get back out here and fight me, you coward!" As Vegeta's body then begins to slide, he then continues, "He's gone! I had him! He was done for, damn it all!" As the Grand Priest is shown having to stare up in the sky, and feeling something ominous, he then comments, "His energy signal has completely vanished from this dimension. He is severely wounded, and unless he heals himself, this clone will die. I fear that he has gone to feed his original body power and information, which only means that he may get even stronger based on your battle against the clone, Vegeta. Nevertheless, you did good for someone who was only able to use such a power for a short time. But I am afraid that we have no time to rest right now. This is only but the beginning of what I fear to be a great war coming between us all." And with the Grand Priest then having to stare at his hands, he then continues, "Never has any of my angels dared to strike me. Never. And he was the first." As he then clenches his fist, he continues, "This act of defiance will not go unpaid." So clearly, the Grand Priest is absolutely upset. No other angel has ever dared to defy him like this, and being the fact that Merno was the first, it looks like the Grand Priest now does have a score to settle with him, as Vegeta is then shown having to revert back down to base form. He then fell down onto his knees as he went along to comment, "I should have finished him when I had the chance. This power is too much. I need to have better control of it. And with the Grand Priest then approaching Vegeta, he went along to then tell him, it is unclear of how much time we have left until he returns, but we must not waste it. We will return to the homeworld of your God of Destruction, Beerus. I am sensing a great conflict happening throughout the multiverse, not just in this universe. I fear that my actions may be required, but I cannot act without the approval of the Omni King. This must come to an end. Come now, warrior. I will heal you and we will make our way back to the others. As only then back with Beerus and Goku, Whis went along to shout, time's up, you two! And with Goku and Beerus having to be shown on their knees, Goku went along to comment, aw man, we were just getting started too! I can't believe you were hiding this much power from me, Lord Beerus. But I will take what you said during our battle into consideration, with Beerus responding, when this is all over, I want a real fight with you, Saiyan. But I too have managed to pick something up from you. We will need it in our battle against the fallen angel. And with Whis shown healing the two, he then went along to tell them, now up you both go. I've noticed the two of you work very well together under pressure. Keep that in mind. And with Goku and Beerus having to be shown getting healed, Goku went along to further look up and asking Beerus, hey Lord Beerus, do you feel that? Vegeta's power has dropped off completely. He's barely alive. With Beerus having to look up, he then responds, yes, and I cannot sense the life energy of the angel either. Which means Vegeta either killed him or he's disappeared. But then, over out in the dark dimension, we get to see how the original Merno is standing in wait as the injured clone emerges out of a portal. The original went along to then comment, I did not call for you to return this quickly, clone. With the clone Merno responding, forgive me for this sudden intrusion, great one. But I am in dire need of aid. This wound will lead me to bleed out if I am not fully healed. I come to you humbly to ask you for, but then, the original Merno then quickly interrupts him by having to turn towards the clone and telling him, wounded by a mortal. Did I not share a small portion of my power to you in order to complete your mission? Yet you return to me with blood on your body that isn't even your enemy's. You failed me, with the clone having to nervously then tell him, I had the mortal right where I wanted him. It was the axe of the Grand Priest that stood in the way of me taking the Saiyan's life. I gathered the energy and information on his power as requested by you. This wound comes from the Grand Priest freezing my body in place in order for the Saiyan to make his move. Surely I would have, but then the original interrupts him again by having to tell him, you were detained, bested by a mortal whose powers are incomplete. You failed. Though I believe I may have been too laxed with you clones. It's time we make sure that this mistake never happens again. And as we then make our way back on over to Beerus's planet, with Whis shown having to stare directly up at the sky and knowing the fact that the battle between Merno and Vegeta had concluded, Whis then went along to utter, the battle has ended. Merno has vanished. And I also sense Vegeta's power dropping off significantly as well. I'm not sure if Vegeta had finished him for good or not. If what my brother had said is true, and there is indeed more to him than what we are led to know, then this may prove to be more troublesome than expected. This is not good, and with Beerus and Goku doing the same thing, Goku went along to chime in by commenting, if we couldn't destroy him and Vegeta wasn't able to get the job either, then what other option is there at this point? It seems as though each time we destroy one, another one just shows up and takes over where the other left off. As Beerus responds, speak for yourself then, Saiyan. There's always a way, no matter the odds. And I don't expect you to be holding back against him the next time we encounter him here either. Who knows what he's up to? So do not jeopardize this operation with your stupidity or you'll pay. With Goku then asking, what do you mean, Lord Beerus? How would I be the one to ruin this? As Beerus went along to point at Goku and responding, because you're the one who always wants to let the enemy live despite the circumstances faced. You will do as you're told, and if it comes to it, finish what has already been started without holding anything back or helping them gain any sort of momentum, got it? Do not make me warn you about this again, or I'll erase you for good. As Goku responds, okay, take it easy, Lord Beerus. I promise I won't do anything to allow him to get ahead of us. You have my word. You better not, says Beerus, as Whis went along to chime in, now's not the time to be bickering, you two. our guests have arrived. And indeed they have, as both Vegeta and the Grand Priest have finally made their way back onto Beerus' planet, the Grand Priest went along to announce to everyone, as I expected, you are all still here. Greetings, with Beerus responding, Grand Minister, you're here! With Goku then having to chime in, yo, welcome back, Mr. Grand Priest! Hey, Vegeta, you look different! You're definitely stronger than before! And with Whis having to be shown bowing, he then comments, welcome back, Grand Minister! It is a pleasure to see you here again with us! With Beerus also doing the same thing, he then comments, welcome back to my planet, Grand Minister, sir! But Goku seems to have a lack of respect as he went along to point at Vegeta and commenting, alright, spill the beans, Vegeta! How strong did you really get? I felt your power from all the way over here. Just what exactly did you do to get this powerful? And with Beerus having to grab onto Goku's head, he then forced Goku in bowing and having to tell him, why must you always be this stupid? You idiot! Bow your head before the Grand Priest and show some respect. As the Grand Priest chimes in, although I appreciate the warm welcome, now's not the best time for formalities in this situation. With Vegeta having to respond, he lives, Kakarot. He's been using us this entire time. Before I could finish him off, he vanished, assumingly back to his original body. So he lives. With Whis then commenting, despite the outcome, Vegeta, you have indeed exceeded your previous limitations tenfold. And with Goku putting this into question, he then went along to ask, yeah, you did. So that power of yours, what exactly was it? It felt like God Ki, but different. Did you discover something beyond our blue forms? Outside of our evolved forms in Kaioken, I really couldn't think of anything that would go beyond that besides Ultra Instinct. So, was that what it was that you have achieved? With Vegeta responding, it was an Ultra Instinct. It was a level combined with the God Ki of Super Saiyan Blue after I had transformed into a Golden Great Ape. It felt as though I had ascended similar to Super Saiyan, but this power was raw and imperfected, but it was enough to give him the wake-up call he deserved, until he escaped me. This power comes from our people, and I call it Primal Super Saiyan Blue, and with Goku taken back, he then responds, wait, hold on, you transformed into a Great Ape and was able to control and combine it with Super Saiyan Blue? Unbelievable, as the Grand Priest went along to then tell Whis, he has been siphoning power to fuel his original body this entire time. As it stands, the entire multiverse is now threatened. Actions from all of the gods of destruction and their angels must be taken. I'm afraid this may become more difficult to handle than previously assumed. You too, says Beerus, as he then proceeds to walk up to both Goku and Vegeta. Beerus then continues, listen to what I'm about to tell you. In case of a dire outcome involving this so-called original Merno, if I were to fall, do not help me. A god has no desire to be saved by mortals in a time of battle. But be that as it may, for the sake of the multiverse, you will set everything aside and work together in this cause to stop what's coming. I don't care what your history with each other is, disobey our orders and you will never live to see another day again. Just like you did during the Tournament of Power, you will both set everything aside for this. Am I understood by the two of you? Especially you, Vegeta. I don't care how much you cannot stand Goku. You will do what you must to work alongside him to make sure that Merno is destroyed once and for all. Failure to do so will be met by the destruction of you both. Do I make myself clear? Yes, sir, says Vegeta. Alright, as the Grand Priest then went along to acknowledge everyone, in order to rid this problem for good, I require you all to be on the same page. Before I take my leave to inform the Omni Kings about the situation, I will attend to make sure this universe is taken care of. As he then went along to spawn a staff and continuing, beginning with this. I believe this belongs to you, Whis. As the Grand Priest then went along to hand over the staff, he then continues, your previous staff was destroyed and spawning a new one only temporarily helped you. Take this. Worry not about the laws of the angels. We shall discuss this at a later time. And as the Grand Priest continues and then having to spawn what seemingly looks like an observational sphere in looking into the other universes, the Grand Priest then continues, as it currently stands, Universe 11 is the second among the 12 to be affected by Merno's presence. Many worlds have seemed to have been destroyed as a result of this conflict, and with Whis doing the same thing on his scepter, he then also went along to chime in. It would also appear that he was there within the 6th and 9th as well. He's been scavenging, as Beerus chimes in, so he's been collecting power is what you're saying, correct, Whis? With Goku responding, and if he's been scavenging for more power, then that will just mean he's going to be even stronger than he was before. Never had there been a time where such action was required, says the Grand Priest, but I need you all to listen very closely to what needs to be done. No matter the odds, you will do what will be needed in order to protect this universe. I shall lift the laws of the angels in order to allow for their assistance in this fight. And with everyone standing around, the Grand Priest then continues, you four will be tasked with defending this universe by any means. As I make my call to the Omni Kings to allow for my actions, each universe will do what they must to defend their worlds and destroy Merno. Hold nothing back, for the fate of everything depends on it. But even as we then make our way back into the Dark Dimension and having to observe the original Merno speak to his clone, he then went along to further glare at him by responding, there will be no room for defective spirits within my mighty vessel. Your purpose has been served. As the original had then proceeded to glare at the clone and having to break his neck right on the spot, he then further proceeded to stick out his finger and responding, I will not tolerate your defiance any longer, clone. And without even breaking a sweat, what the original then does is after he went along to point at the clone and having to blast them into pieces, the original then went along to comment, the hour of punishment has dawned. I've waited generations to seize this moment. I call for the pieces of my spirit to return to me. The great merger has finally arrived. And with portals having to be shown opening all throughout the Dark Dimension, the original then continues, I call for my clones to return to me from the universes in which you have invaded, for the power you have collected, for the knowledge you have obtained. It will now all be one. We will now become one. One mind, one body, one ultimate power, beyond my former glory. And with the original having to be shown extending his hands, we then see in the background how there are dozens and dozens of Merno clones having to be shown standing there. The original then went on to continue, this body and this power will become the ultimate weapon of destruction. As it once was before my exile, we will rip the gods away from their thrones and at last destroy both the Grand Priest and the Omni Kings for what they've done. Now as I call on you all, the time has come. Merge with me now. And as all of the clones are shown having to descend right into the original then is powered by the knowledge, the energy, and all of the experience collected all throughout all 12 universes as the original then went on to utter, yes, yes, this power shall become my ultimate weapon. I could never fall. With this power, body, and knowledge, I could never be defeated. I am complete. And as soon as Merno then is shown having to power up in such a way, with all of these clones having to descend within him, the merger of all of the Mernos is now complete. With a massive burst of energy having to be shown within the Dark Dimension, it is only then that we finally get to see how the original Merno is now complete in all his glory, as he went along to then comment, my former glory has been surpassed. I am whole. And as Merno's hands then begin to glow as he goes on ahead to put them together, Merno then continues, and now to begin the slaughtering of the souls within the multiverse. This will be the first. And as soon as then we get to see how once Merno put his hands together, he then immediately went along ahead to literally tear a hole in space-time as he further went along to stare back out at one of the universes, Merno then comments, my wrath shall be echoed, and your blood will be spilled. And so it starts. I wonder which universe I've managed to cross into. No matter the number, I will make an example with their screams. You all had this coming, and as soon as Merno is then shown having to step through, he then utters, let's proceed. As the portal then goes on to close behind him, Beerus, Goku, Whis, the Grand Priest, everyone then is absolutely at awe in the fact that they're able to detect something within the present multiverse right now, something that seems to have garnered their attention. As Whis then begins to shake, he then utters, what horrifying power? How could he have acquired this much energy? He wasn't bluffing when he said he was preparing. As the Grand Priest responds, He's arrived. But he is not in this universe just yet. He has traveled to another one of the 12. And so it has come to this. And so it shall begin, as only then the Beyond Dragon Ball Super story of Merno vs. Universe 7 manga series then comes to a close. Now, for those who are unaware of the backstory behind all of this, as you guys can see on screen, you guys can go on ahead and check out the two manga series that we have going on the channel, that being the story of how Merno had started and the side story of Merno's invasion within Universe 7 in battling against Broly, Goku, Vegeta, and several other warriors. As of course right now, you guys can go on ahead and find those links located down in the description box below, because the original Merno is now restored and he's looking to extract his revenge in achieving his goals in not only destroying the Gods of Destruction, in getting payback against the Angels, in getting revenge on the Omni Kings, and of course the Grand Priest. This is all going to set up for what's going to happen going forward, as of course Merno now is not only back to full capacity and full strength in returning to his former glory, but now this is going to set the stage in the multiverse's survival against what seemingly is going to be the most difficult task our heroes had ever come across before. And what I found to be very enjoyable about what it was to make this story for everyone was the fact that a lot of people had seemed to have gotten so much joy out of this story and have seemed to have gotten so much entertainment in finally seeing something be done with Beerus, something be done with Whis, having Vegeta evolve past his previous limitations, and having Goku fully be able to utilize and hone the power of Ultra Instinct in using that to his advantage, and seeing how everyone came together to battle against a common enemy. The question going forward is, will our heroes be able to find the power within them to be able to stop such an opponent, or is Merno going to finally set out in completing what he wanted to do since the very beginning, and that's literally destroy the entirety of the multiverse itself, which just so happens to include the Grand Priest, his siblings, and of course the Omni Kings themselves, as of course we are going to have another massive like goal on this video. If we can smash out 12,000 likes on this video, then not only am I going to be inclined in giving you guys the next season slash series soon, but the next series slash season is going to include different perspectives of the clones having to invade Universe 6, Universe 11, and other timelines and dimensions to see what the clones were up to prior to the original's final story in battling against the multiverse itself. But in the comment section below, I want to know some of your favorite moments. I want to know some of the highlights and takeaways from this series, but I also want to know as to what you guys want to see going forward in the story of the original Merno going forward. So again, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. I greatly appreciate you guys so much for sticking around. If of course you guys are new, then be sure to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single video on the channel, as well as giving this video a big thumbs up by slapping that like button down below. Tune back in for more, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody, and take care. Peace. And a quick little reminder before you guys go, if you guys are unaware, I do have a second gaming channel located down in the description box below, so be sure to head on over to Unreal Royale and hit that subscribe button along with turning on all notifications, as to there, you guys will find all different kinds of gaming content that you will not get to find on Unreal and Gaming, titles and video games such as Grand Theft Auto, Call of Duty, Gears of War, Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle, Dragon Ball Z Legends, Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi 3, Minecraft, Blair Witch, and many other retro games on that channel. So if you guys are into gaming, then make sure you guys subscribe over on Unreal Royale. I want to thank you all so much for your time, and I'll catch you all in the next one.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god.
The fuck's up, Bon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes, but Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Freezer.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
Boo, I'm Unreal Gaming! But once you get video, I'll lots of likes, or Boo will turn you into chocolate!
Vados, get over here! Tell these mortals that I'm the biggest Unreal Ent Gaming fan.
This is my moment. I'm a part of his notification squad. Universe 7 can have all the fun. I just want the food.
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video. Show some love for the best community on YouTube.
Kakarot!